You're now listening to the Sneaker Rocks.
Oh shit alert, Louis clothes, calling women sisters, Louboutins and Gucci shows. Well, I guess that goes my Louis shows. More oh shit,
yo.
Your role models a movie bro.
What is the word? This is episode 98, man. We are two away from 100. Like, it's
98.
That's crazy.
Oldsmobile. Oh, you don't know nothing about that.
Dude. See, here you go with the old references. Oldsmobile. I don't.
You know about that?
The Oldsmobile.
Old school rap song, 98 Oldsmobile?
No.
Was that like one of the first rap songs like ever?
Wow.
I know like about 98 Oldsmobile. My first car was like with a 82 Caprice wagon.
I had
I'll educate y'all a little bit later.
Oh man, yeah, tune in for that later on in the show. I think one of my first cars was a Oldsmobile Grand Prix. I mean, not a Grand Prix. Skylark.
I remember Skylark. Skylark.
Yeah. My first car was a Grand Prix, but then my second car was a Skylark, and not the big body one either, like that small. But, you know, when your first cars, man, you from the hood and you broke, you got to take whatever got four wheels and moves.
Yeah, mine, I paid $500 for mine. My radio broke, so the Common City B got stuck in there, so I know that album front to back.
Yeah. I will say this, though. I cannot wait until I get that crib, that house. We working on getting the house now. Mm-hmm. And I love my Durango, but Lord knows I'm dying to upgrade. And the only reason I haven't is because that whole debt-to-income ratio. Mm-hmm. So... as soon as we get the house, as soon as they give us the keys, I'm going straight to the Jeep dealership. Like, yo, SRTA, you are mine.
You get a Jeep SRTA?
I told her, like, that's the next car I'm getting.
That's crazy.
SRTA. I mean, you would think.
It's out cold, but the MPG is like 12 to 13 miles.
You would think, though, with all the tickets I get, like, that would be the last car I would want. But
I like the Durangos, or the new Durangos.
But they're getting rid of the Durangos. For some reason, they're going to cut off the Durangos.
This one, I feel like they sold a lot of the new ones. The new ones are nice.
Yeah, I agree with you, but, you know, the Jeep brand is going to be here forever, so. And Jeeps, I mean, not that because I just worked there either, but Jeeps are actually, like, a great car. Great, great car. Especially here in Michigan, you know, having an SUV is, like, valuable in the winter. Mm-hmm. So, in any event, I am the African Caesar.
All hail Caesar, Emperor of Rome. Monarch of the Roman Empire, ruler of the world.
Hail Caesar! Hail Caesar!
That's right.
Hail Caesar!
Then I got Big Bro in the room, JumpmanBostic.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Pop that top, baby.
That Mountain Dew. Man, I'm telling you right now, we need to get that sponsorship with Mountain Dew. As much as you drink of it. Man. I feel like you single-handedly are keeping them in the black, too. Like,
yeah, I'm stacked up in the garage. Never run out.
You can't even park his car in the garage.
I mess with Mountain Dew since that high school rumor. When they had, with the
oh,
Mountain,
the low sperm count? Yeah.
I don't even worry about that no more. I'm down.
Is that why you drink that so much?
Keep it down, bro. Keep it down.
When you get that old, you got to start shooting. You got to start shooting hollow tips. Gotta start shooting hollow tips.
Shooting them blanks.
So I shoot blanks all day right now.
Pew pew.
No doubt.
Damn.
Green blanks.
Oh. It's too early in the morning for this shit. Oh man, hold on. I'm crying. And then we got my man Guru in the building.
The Roshi Run music. I had some Nike Presto music. I know I didn't earn some Nike Presto music or something.
Oh, man. You know, real quick, too, shout out to our listeners, man. Like, in the month of September alone, we got 2,000 more downloads per episode. Not just in the month, per episode. I think we all know what facilitated that, but...
Nobody's listening, though.
Oh, yeah, no. You know, irreplaceable.
I wonder why we on that. I want to give a shout out to Charles 2483. He always comment on pictures and asking about the show. And the other gentleman was Brandon _Rogers_45_. They always showing their support for the show and comment on our post. So shout you guys out. Appreciate y'all.
You know what's cool though? It's a lot of times. Well, I'm not gonna say a lot of times, but there's been times where, like, you know, somebody wants to argue or complain about something on the show. But the cool thing is we're able to have a conversation, and usually it ends with them or ends with us being like, okay, you know, all right, you know, I respect your opinion, or, you know, they walk away not being as angry as they as the way they start the conversation off. Mm-hmm. And so that's what it's all about for me, is like the dialogue. I want anybody, if you got anything nice to say, anything bad to say, like, hit us up. We can always talk about it. So, mm-hmm. But for the most part, everybody seems to be enjoying the show. I know a lot of people are like, oh, you guys are Jordan heavy. So, you know, we're going to try our best to be more rounded in our shoe talk.
It's hot.
I know Gavin came in with a crowd of people, his own fan club, the Gsnks fan club.
Man. It's hard not to, man. You got Gavin the Jumpman on the board of directors for the Jordan brand. So. They got stock in Jordan, man, so it's hard, man. Y'all got to bear with us, man.
I guess I just walked right into it.
Yeah, basically.
I walked right into it.
They was just waiting.
I know. Real talk,
I got here before you, so I had to get you.
I swear to God, I see that in the parking lot. Like,
hey, guru. Pew, pew. We shooting those shots today. Pew, pew.
Shooting blanks. It feels good. You know, to get targeted.
Building a house of brick.
It feels good. We'll see on the 16th.
Right.
The 23rd.
We'll see.
Real talk though, I gotta tell you, that sweater and that shirt is dope though. Like,
thank you.
I saw that. I've been meaning to text you and tell you that. So.
Oh well, whatever, whenever. Hey. Well, I guess I gotta give you a discount for being late.
4X. Yeah, I know.
Yeah, so,
yeah, I know.
It's very hard to
like a $30 discount. Like,
it's very hard to sneak in when the boss sitting right at the table. You just gotta.
I know. Like, I'm staring right at the door too.
Got a write up coming.
Oh, can you close it all the way too? Somebody? All right, cool. Yeah. All right. In case you didn't know, you've been listening for 15 minutes. You would think you would know by now, but this is the Sneaker Boss Podcast with Sneaker Bar Detroit, a part of the Crep Protect family. What's the point of spending all your money on your shoes if you're not going to keep them clean long enough to get your money's worth? Practice safe stunting. Go to crepprotect.com and get your shoes some protection. Also, make sure to follow us on social media. You can follow us on Instagram at @thesneakerbox_podcast. You can follow us on Twitter by searching The Sneaker Box Show, and on Facebook by simply looking up The Sneaker Box Podcast. And if you'd like to talk to us live on the podcast, you can call us at toll-free 888-799-5267. Also, if you work in retail and you got any type of crazy stories, you can email us or message us on social media and, you know, give us a detailed story about your experience. You ain't give us your full information. Just give us like your first name so we don't get you in any type of trouble. All right. First, before I break into the top 10, go blue. I don't know, MSU, man. 2 L's in 2 weeks. Like, Wisconsin is one thing, even though we beat them. But then y'all lost to Indiana in overtime. Like, first of all, like, y'all shouldn't even went to overtime. And then y'all took an L in overtime. So I just wanted to put that out there. Shout out to Sneaky Girl. All right. So we got our... We got the Sneaker Box Fab Five releases from the previous week, brought to you by Puffer Reds, Michigan's number one sneaker boutique. You can check out both of the store locations in Wayne and Ypsilanti, Michigan, or you can go to the website at pufferreds.com. All right, so number five, we have the Puma Clyde Wraith. Is it Wraith or Wrath? Wraith Pack. Dope shoe.
That's Wraith. Wraith talk.
Yeah, Wraith.
That's Wraith.
Okay, cool. I just want to make sure I'm pronouncing that right. You know, Wraith. I'm Ron Burgundy.
Wraith talk.
Puma Clyde Wraith Pack, it's dope. You got a black pair and you got a burgundy pair.
Yeah, those look real nice.
Real nice. The materials are just great. Excellent use of patent leather.
And suede too.
Yeah, that's suede. I mean, it's Puma doing their thing this year. I mean, with Rihanna, and then actually they've been doing a real good job with the Puma Clyde too. Last couple colorways have been dope. Just being real low key, a lot of people sleep on them.
Would you take the Clydes or the Air Force Ones?
Ooh, right now?
I take the Clydes.
I was going to say, what? Right now?
Oh, my God.
I'll take the Clydes.
I mean, you can't go wrong with a classic pair of all-white Air Force Ones. But
you can't go wrong with a tie. I know, Nike over here, man. This guy.
I never. Come on, man. You can never. And I just happened to wear Air Force Ones today, so you can't. You can't. I just happened.
He saw that when you walked in.
No. I didn't see that.
Oh, he's taking no shots.
Pew pew.
No. I'm just saying, like, all white Air Force Ones don't sell like that no more. But I prefer, like, you get more wear out of that than the post. As soon as you bought two wears of the Air Force Ones, when it gets that crease. You know, I just something like that. So you can wear
well, that's casual. Not all white.
I'm saying, like, even, like, the blue pair or the red pair.
I mean, it's Air Force Ones that you can get wears out of.
Black. I like both. I ain't going to hate on either one. I'm just saying.
Nah, I'm anti-Nike, man. My favorite signature athletes are...
LeBron. Well, like, LeBron. Right. Like, everybody know LeBron.
But Penny Hardaway. You know
the top five
favorite athletes. We know LeBron. Right.
Yeah, LeBron. Yeah, LeBron. 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 LeBron.
James.
Don't worry. When they start retroing, I'm going to be Dunkman. I'm going to be Dunkman Robinson. That's what my name is. So as soon as he start retroing.
He going to have stock in LeBron.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh, wow. Number four. We have the 10 Corso Ooh. Como Special Edition A6 Gel Light 3. Yeah. I mean, even a box is dope.
Yeah,
the box is dope. Yeah, A6 is dope. Man, A6 been doing anything. I think people are starting to catch on if they haven't already.
Nike getting their behind whooped in the lifestyle brand.
Yes.
It's not even, everybody. Every single body. They getting their behind whooped in the lifestyle brand.
Not even a question. A6 New Balance. Diadora, they definitely stepped their game up this year. Especially, what was that? Diadora had that that Rio pack?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Shout out to the guy, whoever got, like, every pair out of that pack, because there's only 500 pairs per colorway. I think it was, like, 6 or 7 colorways. Mm-hmm. Yeah, shout out to that guy that got every pair of shoes in that collection, because every shoe in there was a banger. Number three, I don't know. Anybody in this room get these? The Air Jordan Retro 12 Wool?
Yeah.
I know you got them.
Yeah.
JB, I know you got them.
No.
No?
No.
I didn't really care for the wool. I guess
house before shoes.
Right. Yeah, that's
priorities. Priorities, fellas.
That's it. Thank you.
Priorities, fellas.
But with patience.
With patience.
Yeah, he'll end up getting them. You'll see a video like maybe sometime early next year. So.
Our pairs didn't look so much like, in the pictures they looked dope, but in person they wasn't as pleasing.
Actually, I'm total opposite. They look better in person. And then a lot of the pairs had different characteristics. Like the wool wasn't the same shade on all of them.
Yeah, that's what the problem. Mine was like a grayish brownish. That's what kind of turned me off. The other pairs were like a gray on them. So
I thought it was dope. I thought it was dope the way it did that. The quality was good. They was comfortable as hell. You know?
That's what I heard. That was the one word everybody kept saying was comfortable.
Yeah, the tongue on it is super soft.
And I wonder if because it was the mule material, so I guess it stretches better than the leather. So I don't know. But, yeah, I missed out on those, too. So if anybody got a size 15 for retail. Number two.
And that was the size. That was the last size left to go, 14s or 15s. Like, if you walked in the store, that's all they were saying, 14s, 15s, 14s, 15s.
Oh, God. I could 14s, 15s. Yeah. I know Jumpman got his house situation going on. I got my house situation going on, so it's kind of like priorities. Number two, you have the A6 Aurora Borealis collection. I wanted to say Gel Light 3. I just got into the habit of saying that. Scroll down. Like it's two shoes in that bag. Man, that shoe goes so hard. Each shoe in there. Scroll down a little bit more. It's another shoe. Yes. Yeah, both of those go so hard. Like you just said, A6, all these lifestyle runners or whatever. Mm-hmm. I mean, they've been killing it. They've been killing it with the concepts and just the execution. I don't know. I mean, I could talk about them all day. Unfortunately, they do not make a size 15, so I'm just SOL. So I get to look at them or I get to live vicariously through somebody who is able to fit an A6. And it's funny, why do they not, I mean, I understand, maybe they just think, like, people size 14, 15, 16 just wouldn't buy the shoe, at least enough to justify making them, so, I don't know. But you would think differently with all the athletes and whatnot wearing large sizes, you would think that they would accommodate.
Send them an email saying, hey, I would be interested 14, 15. Now that they have somebody, you send you a buy, they probably, place an order with you.
Yeah, they listen to the show, so maybe me saying that will, get something rolling, get the ball rolling. All right, and I think everybody knows what number one is. Get that drum roll, please, sir. The most obvious number one I think we've had.
Oh, my God.
got the Air Jordan Retro 12 OVO.
Oh, my God.
Lights.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
A little starstruck right now.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I didn't even bother. I just didn't. I didn't even bother because took L's. Shout out to my man Dwight at Puffer Reds because I know I saw his post on Facebook. He said the shoe guys looked out for him. So,
man.
You know, if you got lucky, you have reason to be happy this weekend. If you didn't...
If you got lucky, you should be playing a lottery right now.
I mean, at this point, I think people are just accustomed to taking L's. So I ain't see too many angry people.
Ain't no need to be.
No.
I just don't know what's the point of not making that more readily available. You know it's going to sell out. You know
it's all about the hype. Like, it's all about demand. Like, it's driving...
I mean, but yeah, the hype, you could at least make it...
The more limited hypeable, you make something, the more people want it.
But I think my only issue with the release is that they should have dropped the black one in the fall and then dropped the white one like when the summer's breaking.
That makes too much sense.
I think that would have been way more. You would have sold more paraphernalia. You know, something about a white hoodie in November. You know what I'm saying? Like,
oh, that really. Stuff is gone.
Yeah. You know, they bought it to resell that the Twitter for hype of them. I'm just saying for like
that stuff is gone.
You want the people to wear it though.
Down
you know
to
saying?
The headband and that wristband, all that.
Yeah, because it's for resale, just like they do with the Supreme clothes. So it's reaching that status. That's the direction they're going.
It really don't matter. I mean, but then again, they would have dropped two black 12s on the same day because the Wolves came out the same
day. They could have pushed it back like they did every other.
But I'm saying they would have. Those were still sold.
Yeah,
I mean it was all gonna sell regardless. Yeah, but all. It's not what they dropped. It's just how they dropped it. You know what I'm saying? Like one store in Chicago. Like, come on.
And online.
And
online.
And not even like we didn't even get a chance.
Wait. Somebody. I thought some Nike Towns got it because I swear I saw. Because people like, what was it Friday night? Was showing that they didn't win a raffle.
The OVO app, they got them. The OVO store in Los Angeles and Toronto. I know one Foot Locker in Indianapolis got it, and then that Nike Town in Chicago. And then probably maybe one other store.
Maybe that's what it was.
No, it was Jordan store in Chicago. The Jordan Foot Action store.
Yeah, maybe that's what it was.
I didn't see no in Indianapolis, though.
I saw that on the Foot Locker.
We got a lot of callers. Hey. Let's get to the ugliest release of the week. You had the... That drop.
Super ugly.
Yeah, you got the Pendleton Special Edition Nike SFB 6-inch boot. Shoes are trash. Hold on, we about to pull them out now. We got all these collars going in. Jeez. But yeah, as soon as that picture pops up.
You finally took the boots off of there, huh?
I'm telling you, I put it there every week for you. I'm telling you.
He took them off, but they still on my mind.
Oh, they're
right. Terrible.
They still on my
mind as being terrible.
They're still on my hit list.
Stop it. Man.
Yeah, they still on my hit list. But those happen to be worse.
That's the stepbrother of them.
Oh. Right.
You see him? Look at him. Look at him.
This the prototype right now.
Look. Them the wool future boots.
Oh man, that's
the...
Hey, look.
Look like somebody blind.
I don't look at
time.
Hey, Gavin, eat the Doritos, y'all.
Gavin gonna get like, man, these are sweater 11 boots.
Those are wool 11 boots.
They was, I got them off the sneakers app.
Man, oh my god, yeah. If you wearing those around me, you will get clowned. I'm just giving you a heads up. We got some other ugly honorable mentions. You have the Nike Cortez leather. I don't know if I can recover from that.
Yeah.
Nike Cortez leather black anaconda. Look,
that's
snakeskin.
Not as bad.
That's just that's it. Deep. Don't look right at all. It looks like a Lego shoe.
I mean, it's a Cortez though. I mean,
Dave likes that. Dave was crazy. Yeah. It looks like a shoe's made out of Legos. Right. Like I don't know what it is, but that snakeskin usually looks good on the shoe.
That looks straight. It's just Cortez is just like 1985 kickball shoes to me. And they the way that toe shape, the way that toe shape is a home run every time, man. I mean, the Dope Boys, you know, that's y'all shoes. I ride a wide.
Like if Sonic the Hedgehog was a person, he would wear the Cortez. I don't know, man. That snakeskin, it doesn't even look at that, Jay. Like it looks like a Lego shoe. It looks like somebody made a shoe out of Legos and called it snakeskin.
That looked like a reptile that just attacked your foot and bite.
Yeah, that's
it
what
off.
It looks like a snake though.
Yeah, well,
come on, no Legos. You must be still playing PlayStation 2.
Man, this
that's how the shoes because
it
look
looks
on.
Blocky. It doesn't look like scales. It looks like blocks. It's not executed properly. Let me see what else. Okay, we have the Adidas ZX Flux 5.8 TR. Maybe it's the colorway.
Them
maybe
trash.
If I saw
them trash. Them Cortez look better than those. Them trash. I hate Z Fluxes with a passion.
I don't hate the ZX Flux, but I hate that boot.
Oh, y'all like that. Stop playing.
What? That y'all boot like is that. Garbage. I mean, it's the colorway, too. So I want to give it a fair chance. Maybe if I saw a black pair or a brown pair,
black, nothing,
maybe I would feel differently.
trash.
It's a Roshi Ron with traction.
Did you see that's he tried it to? If, maybe if it was a black pair.
No I put it on the list.
No way in hell, bro.
Hey, time out. No I put it on the list. Bro. I put it on the list. Obviously, no I'm not attracted bro. To it. Maybe I'm just trying to be fair. Pair.
No, not even. Man. No way in hell.
For
bro.
The sake.
Y'all say the Jordan boot is ugly.
Look at that shit. Come
that's why. What, where is it at right now? Oh, the ugly honorable mention list?
Come on now.
Look, I'm saying for the sake of the ZX Flux fans, I'm going to be objective and say, look. Maybe if I saw a different colorway, maybe
bro,
I could
no.
And no. I said no. Maybe.
And the shoe got maybe. A, and the shoe got a turtleneck on it. It looked like a Roshi Ron, a football.
And
clip.
They put a V-neck. A pull tab on the back for whatever reason.
They put a V-neck on it. Like, why?
A sweater V-neck.
Wear your chain outside.
Yeah. But yeah. I'm telling you, your feet should never be cold in that shoe.
And the pull tab like made out of like terry cloth.
It looked like they tried to just mock. Everything Nike. They got a back retro 6 pull tab. They got a retro 8 booty. They got man, a duck boot bottom. Like, just stop, man. Just put it back in the...
Look, please. Everything ain't meant to be a
you
boot.
You talking about another color. No.
Look, man, I'm no. just saying. I'm trying to be objective. I'm trying to be fair to the ZX Flux fans.
That
out
shoe
there.
Is what's wrong with sneaker culture right there.
Nah, it's beyond.
Period.
It's beyond Z Flux. It is beyond the Z Flux because it was said, probably for the Z Flux.
He said that's the tip of the iceberg right there. And then last but not least, this shoe might be the worst. The Nike SB Stefan Janowski camo.
Why is it a whole bunch
Jumpman
of
Jumpman almost died.
On
what
list?
The hell? Jumpman almost died. Somebody give him CPR.
Because you ever noticed that these are all the shoes that we posted were all that were Nike were lifestyle brand shoes, and that the lifestyle brand shoes are from Nike are so terrible compared to the Yeezys and the ASIC gel like threes and the New Balances 580s and 599s and all those. That's why they're on this list.
I don't know what to say about this shoe though.
You know why I agree with that? You know why? Because Nike has room to experiment. Adidas, everybody else, it has to look as best as it can for it to sell.
That's a valid argument.
Nike, they got so much stuff. They can experiment. They can, all right, let's take that far.
I wish they didn't experiment with this because I don't know what the hell.
They're taking a lot of L's.
Yeah, they're taking a lot of L's.
Ah, man.
That's a hell of L there.
Thank you. I want somebody to try to defend
that's California.
Because the lifestyle brand now is almost getting to the point where the basketball brand is because some people like, I don't like gym shoes. I don't like gym basketball shoes. They're too bulky. With the lifestyle brands, you got the dudes who wear suits all the time, interested in Yeezys and New Balances, J-Lite 3s. And then right. You got people like us who want to take a break from the Jordans or the signature athlete shoes. We can wear the lifestyle brands.
Right. People like you.
Bro, I ain't the only one. I ain't the
but
only
that
shoe, one.
That shoe right
there. I ain't the only one.
That shoe right there got California all over it. That shoe right there got California.
Hey, this road trip going to be live, too.
Hey, this almost looked like your KD7 pony hairs that you love so dearly.
Nah, that's worse. That's worse. That's way worse.
Nah, don't KD7 ponies.
Nothing is worse. I want people to look up the Stefan Janowski camo. Yeah, trash. Let's get to these callers, though. Marco's been waiting for, like, literally half an hour. Marco, Georgia.
What's going on?
What's up?
Not a damn thing, man. How y'all fellas doing?
Good, right.
ATL in the building.
Hey, man, my voice look gold because I was, you know, when your team break history just like they did yesterday, going for 500 yards and 300 yards and receiving yards and 12 catches, you know what I mean? You lose your voice screaming and hollering and stuff like that.
I'm glad we have a modest Atlanta Falcons fan on the phone.
Hey, all day. Yeah. But, man, I'm not salty about the L that I took. What I'm pissed off about is how just last week on the Sneakers app, I can get the Dave White Air Max 95s, no problem. This week, you tell me that my password has been changed. I didn't change that shit. So who in the hell changed my password? You know
Nike.
What I mean? Like, don't give me that BS. You know what I mean?
I was wondering about that because I saw the same thing.
Mikey had us all in there trying to refresh our password and change the password.
Yeah.
They had a bunch of people messed up.
20 minutes later, it works now. I didn't change no password or nothing like that. Oh, now it works. Really?
So you saying somebody hacked into your account? to get those OVOs?
Man, they blocked some bots blocked us. Some bots blocked us out.
I feel like that's what I feel like. And I called Nike. She giving me some BS excuse about, oh, well, two shoes dropped.
First of all, I like the. First of all, I like the way you say you called Nike and said she as if it's one person, like as if Nike is just this one person that you can just talk to.
Be like, bitch, I don't give a fuck about those shoes dropped that day.
You know what I mean? Hell, so I'm like, man, that's that bullshit. Like, I can take an L, but don't play with me while I'm taking it.
Yeah, that's true.
But you know, every time you call, I think I enjoy myself.
That was funny. Yeah,
you know, I'm the one that won the book. You know, doing the encyclopedia and stuff. You know, I was gonna bring the sneaker con, but you know, Jumpman didn't show up, so I could get it signed. So,
Well, don't bring that. Oh man, I'm telling you, I don't even know if he just got over it yet.
NYC, baby.
I know we got New York to look forward to, but it's not Atlanta.
Man, can you make it to Atlanta?
Hey, I'm down here.
Can you make it to Atlanta? I mean, to New York?
I'm in Atlanta.
No, can you make it to
Hell
New York?
No. Hell no. I'll see you next year.
Unless something else pop up.
I mean, you could just send it back. Might show up. Send it back. You know, send it back, sign it, then send it down.
I tried to tell Caesar to let me sign it. And he was like, I don't know if he wanted to be signed. I'm just going to send it to him.
I would have took his side, man. I would have took his side.
Crack him in his head.
Man, see? And he beat me with a selfie stick. Like, I already hate the selfie stick to begin with.
Go get a switch off the tree.
Oh, man. That's old school.
And you come back with a little switch and they go get the whole damn tree?
Right. You come back with the bark, the trunk of the tree.
We get it signed for you, though, brother.
Yeah, we'll make it happen. All
right. Yes, sir. Hey, man, but hey, I love the show, man. You know, y'all doing y'all thing, man.
All right, appreciate it, man.
Appreciate it, man. Thanks.
Yeah, have a nice one.
Yes, sir. Let's knock out these last two, then. Brandon from Las Vegas. Uh-oh, get ready. It's going to be at least a 10-minute conversation right here with Brandon.
Man, what's going on, man?
What's up?
He put you out there like that.
That's cold. I'm going to quit calling the show now.
No, you don't do that. I just wanted to give everybody a heads up. Like, this turned into the Brandon show. On sneakerbirddetroit.com.
Hey, man, I'm just trying to get a spot on the show. That's all I'm trying to do. But hey, man, I want to talk to y'all. Did y'all see the Michigan Jordan collection?
Yes, we did.
I got tagged in some videos and pictures. Man.
Yeah. So go ahead and tell me how ugly the 31s were, Caesar.
Look, I'm going to tell you like this. I'm only going to buy it because it's Michigan, if they ever come out. That's it.
What? Hell.
Did you hear
that? Hell no, man.
What is the hell no?
That is no.
That reeked
hype business.
Right.
But that's your brother, though.
Hold on. Time out.
No, man.
That's your brother. That's your teammate.
To buy an ugly shoe. To say buy an ugly shoe. Listen, the colorway that he feel is ugly.
Hey, Jumpman.
Hold on. Time out.
No.
I'm glad he ain't on our team.
Right.
Time up.
Right. They can't even team up together.
Everybody's mics off.
This is being real with each other.
Listen. I'm gonna tell y'all this. Look, and I said this before. You can have an ugly silhouette, but there's a good colorway that'll come out of that ugly silhouette. And y'all wanna call me a hypebeast for buying Michigan apparel? Call me a hypebeast. Because I will buy anything Michigan. I'm telling you right now, if it got Michigan on it, I'm buying it.
Nah, I see about
that Adidas stuff.
What?
They stuff is trash. I couldn't get past that.
That's ultra hype.
They couldn't even get the colorway right.
Did you hear that shit, bro? If it says Michigan, I'm buying it.
What? Just because it had Michigan on the bottom of the shoe.
You know what?
Right.
Brandon, why you call in? Why you start shit? We was having a good show until Brandon called in.
Brandon, you helped bring out the high distance.
Send that crap back.
It's a big ass. It's
put the crap in the box and send it back.
Major hype.
Send it back.
Wow.
Jumpman, this is my theory on what Caesar just did.
Okay.
He's already gone as far as to say the 31 is garbage. Exactly. But he knows when he saw it, he thought it was real nice. But now he's already put himself out there.
He's just got to roll with what he said.
Exactly. He can't turn back no more.
But now
Michigan color come out.
Yeah.
And now he's like, oh, well, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess.
Yeah.
That's sad.
I'm going to be in line. Dave, Dave, I'm telling you right now, ban all phone calls from Las Vegas from now on.
We gonna have you come through every time you call.
Hey, Brandon, you can call my phone, bro. Call my phone, Brandon, and I get you on there.
Man,
we on a Las Vegas ban.
But I do have a question. I need your guys' help. I think only Caesar and Jumpman can help me.
We ain't got no more OVOs.
No, I'm good. I'm good on the OVOs. So I don't know. Did you guys see the pictures of the 15s that are coming out next year?
Yep.
Yes, okay, sir. So I know Caesar like them. Yep. I know Jumpman like them. I love the 15. Mm-hmm. So I'm doing what I'm always doing. I show the wife, hey baby, look, the 15s are coming out. And her answer was, that is by far the ugliest fucking shoe I've ever seen in my life.
Oh.
And you're not going to buy that shoe. And if you do buy it, you're never wearing it around me.
Whoa. Wow.
So my question
first of all,
is,
abuse goes both
Brandon,
ways.
Can I just
man.
Ask you a question first? Just one question first.
What's up, Doug?
Did you just assume that me and Guru don't have girls? Or why?
No. I was assuming that you guys didn't like the 15.
Why not? I had the condom pack with the Asian 15s. I like the black and red ones and the black and stuff. Them the two ones that I like.
That's the one coming out, the black and stuff.
Yeah, them the ones I like.
Why do you assume that I don't like 15s? Because I'm not 30 plus?
Damn.
What? No, both of you.
I'm just.
Nowhere near 30.
So, wow.
I ain't even in that range.
I'm 30 just,
plus. Wow. That's like 30 to 40. I'm 53. I naturally like the 15.
30 plus. Only reason why I said 30 plus is because I'm 27. I'm pushing 30. So, do I have to be over the 30 hump to like 15?
No, you don't have to be over 30.
You know see how he's trying to make us have some beef here?
I just don't know why I wouldn't like 15.
You said 30 plus means 30
no,
to 40.
Because you know what?
But no.
Most people don't like
them.
You're right. Most people don't like the 15.
That is by far the most hated Jordan I've ever seen in my life. And every time I wear them, I get clowned.
No, that might be.
The 21s and the other ones, what was it, 22 that man Spalding? Why is they starting today? Air Force Ones, 21s.
The Spaldings. The one, the 22s that was made out of the Spaldings.
Those are trash. Those are the thing.
And the 2009.
Trash to me, but.
Put it up on your phone. I can't remember.
The 2009.
The basketball leather.
Oh, them? Yeah, the 2009.
Go.
Oh, damn.
The 2009s would look like women's loafers with the little heel in the back. Gray Island wore.
Yeah,
when he was in Boston, those were terrible too. That was like.
Did I just hear Caesar say? But if they came in Michigan colors, he would cop them.
They did.
Brandon, why are you still on the phone? Why is he still here?
If it was that blue Michigan basketball leather, I would buy them 22.
Oh. I'll have them on right now. I'm gonna tell everybody to go to hell like right now, like right now. Nah, there's a bus pulling.
Who
would
have came to the show in the day?
That's what the 22s, man.
But I will say out of that Jordan collection, man. I like the retro 12s were probably my favorite. Those I love the 16s with those.
Yes,
16s. The 16s were super dope.
Yes, 17s were dope.
The threes were nice.
The threes and mm-hmm. sevens.
Yeah, they seemed to focus.
Them
11s
were gorgeous.
Yeah. Yes,
like threes. They was actually might wear those in the game.
Yeah.
Which ones?
The threes.
Yeah,
they focused on them a lot.
31s was nice. So I,
the 12s were fantastic.
The 11s probably
the 12s
was
amazing. Hazel blue make anything look good.
Yeah, the 20s were dope.
The 8s were outstanding with those straps.
I bet, yeah. The 8s.
Yeah.
The 20s were dope, too.
Okay, but wait a second. Hold on. We got off track. I got a question. I need help.
Okay. We can't get none for you just because we up here.
Wife, no, he want to
know. No, it's your show. I mean, we only got like an hour left. Go ahead.
Just buy the shoe, man.
So here's the thing. Okay, well, here's my question. So she threw a fit. She also did the same thing with the phone posits, so I don't know how next year's going to work with that. So my question is do I leave her now or when the shoe drops?
Man, you want to file first.
No.
Damn sure want to do that.
Yeah, you want to file first, man.
All right, so, I'm just checking because I can't have that.
Don't fall asleep.
If you finna divorce her, what she look like?
Damn.
Hey, man.
Hey, you see what jurors do to you?
Yeah. Man, right. I'm just saying. He's been a dumper.
You leave Barbara for that.
Look, I'm just saying.
Brandon, you call me talking shit, right? And this dude want to know what your wife look like so he can go shoot his shot in Las Vegas.
That's what happens when you. That's what happens.
Wow. Like,
man, he finna divorce her.
He ain't even filed yet. You talking about how she looks.
That's what happens. That's what OVO 12 do to you.
He trying to size your wife up.
Damn.
Wow. Hey, you better spread some prep protect on your wife.
I know, right?
Practice safe marriage. Practice safe marriage.
Right.
Hey,
you did a good job. That was tight.
With all due respect, Brandon, with all due respect, you said you was finna divorce her. Man, you finna be back on the market.
You have to gather proof your wife.
I'm trying to see if Vegas is the move for me. You know what I'm saying? So,
Oh man.
First off, you better make sure she don't hear this episode.
Right. That's one. Yeah. This might be the first one he doesn't play for.
If I get a Vegas follower on IG, I know who it's from.
Man. Because if you don't do something, get those shoes.
If we go to
you don't want her to burn your shoes.
If we go to SneakerCon in Las Vegas, if they ever go there, I'm telling you, we're going to need security just to protect Gavin from Brandon. Brandon gonna just attack him like a wild banshee.
Hey, Brandon, we can meet in the MGM parking lot. How about
what?
That?
You setting up the fight?
Mayweather versus Pacquiao.
Are we trying to create Tupac? What happened? What are we doing? Ooh, why we gotta meet in the MGM, man?
He'll catch you slipping.
Oh, man.
Dang, the podcast took a turn for a worse. Like, we was all talking about shoes, and all of a sudden, dude want to sleep with his wife. That's crazy.
But no. But on the real, though, I'm going to get him anyway. I don't care what she say. I just wanted to call in and say what's up to y'all.
No,
talk about the Michigan things. Them 15s are fantastic. I love how they look. I can't wait for them to drop. I really can't.
Yes, sir.
No problem, man.
So, just wanted to say what up to everybody. Hope y'all have a good show, man.
Definitely.
All right, thank you, man. Appreciate it.
All right, Brandon.
We'll see you. Let's get to Lionel real quick, too, since he's been patiently waiting. Wow. I don't even know how to follow that one up. Yeah. You actually tried to shoot his shot. Like, he was like,
he said he divorcing her.
He ain't even got to that point. He ain't divorced her yet.
But he talking about it. I just said, what does she look like just to throw it out there?
No rim, no board. No board.
See?
That's an old school saying.
Man. You said, repeat that one more time.
Panties. No rim, no board, just cord. That means all net, baby.
Yeah, he was trying to go panties with his wife.
All legs, baby.
Remember that Nike commercial with the ray guns that was playing basketball in the Rucker? Come on, I know you remember the commercials, though. When Vince Carter had the ray guns jersey on and they was hooping at the Rucker with Boosty Collins and them was playing.
Oh, okay. I somewhat slightly remember it.
Come on, Caesar, man. You gotta keep it, man.
I'm supposed to remember every commercial that ever came out.
Real hype beaches today.
Y'all got to get your teamwork together, man.
Right.
Oh, Lionel was there? Oh, Lionel, Chicago.
What's going on? What's going on?
Not much.
What's up?
None of us. I ain't calling in a while. My bad.
You gotta apologize.
You good, man. As long as you listen.
Yeah. Hey, I've been listening. What's been going on? I seen y'all was at the Atlanta Sneaker Show. It was turned up, I saw.
Man, yeah, that was live. Like, I've only been to a couple sneaker cons, and that was by far the best one I've been
to. Yeah, I had met Gucci Man, Young Jeezy, Future. They was all up in there. I met him, kicked it with all of them, yep.
He is lying his ass off.
He turned into an Uber driver at the mailbox parking lot, too. They lured them. They said, we got some OVO.
Hey, just for a second, I'd be like, what?
Oh, man.
OVOs.
Oh, man. Hey, why do I feel like it was an OVO on a string and they were just dragging, pulling it, and he's chasing it. He chased it into the parking lot.
Like, a little farther.
Got him.
Oh, well.
Hey, look, it was a box being held up with a stick, and it was an OVO under it.
Oh, dude, up the Family Guy.
Oh, Gavin, we got some OVOs.
I got some popsicles in my cell.
You almost had it. You almost had it.
Good, I'll be quicker than that.
All right, I give y'all that one.
They trapped them in a box. It was y'all can have that one. Up with a box with an OVO underneath.
All right, y'all can have that one. Okay, y'all can have that one.
They trying.
Give y'all one.
They trying to come back.
They trying. They trying. They got makeup. They got to make up.
Oh, man.
Hey, because dude hit me on Instagram and asked me did I have that toenail pic.
Oh, did he?
He did. I swear to God, he did. Yeah, he, I did.
Oh, man. Ah, time to get turned up.
Right. How many months? Dude can't. I told y'all he comes with. How many cans of models you come in with?
Three of them.
Jeez.
Jeez. Big dog. Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Go ahead, line that.
Yeah, thanks for starting that rumor.
Oh, man.
Thank you for that.
Hey, but, hey, when T-Con comes to Chicago, I would love to have y'all in my city, Chicago.
I would love to
have y'all. We went, was that?
I think it's coming in December.
December?
December?
Yeah.
Okay, then, well then I'll see y'all there then.
I was almost, sure. I almost came to Chicago Friday and Saturday trying to get me some OVOs.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll be there.
Yeah, we'll be there, though. Well, yeah, question about the 2017 releases.
Oh yeah, it's a lot of 13s coming out.
French Blue. Flint.
Yeah, Flint. And
Bleed
the
Boys. The chair. Well, they call them chair, but the Bleed Boy. The Bleed 13.
Yeah, y'all know. Y'all know why they call them Bleeds, though. We know, though.
I don't know.
Come on with that knowledge.
Technically,
come on. Why?
Technically, it was only
two of them.
Two pairs that bled. It was the Cranberries and it was the Flints from 06, 05.
No,
and
the Cherries bled.
The Cherries, no, it can't bleed because they
Cherries bled. No, the OG 99s bled.
But you couldn't really see it though with that black.
Yes, you could. Yes, you could.
And on the, after probably a while, the star on the back near the white, it started to go
the
up.
The Gray Toes did too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, those are the most notorious ones.
Gray Toes did.
And the Flints from 05 wasn't even ink, it was glue. It was that burgundy glue that was coming from under that suede.
Yeah, but I'm geek. I want give me a pair. Why, of
hold on before you go. Why? What was the reason for the bleed?
I to be honest with you, I don't know reason for the bleed.
It was the material they used, that suede they used.
So that's what it is. I knew they bled.
You ain't
all
know
the
that
time that was bad. I knew they bled. I didn't know why they bled.
I just
yelling at you. Yeah. Right, I guess a Law and Order episode.
You ain't gonna catch me slipping, bro. But nah, I'm geek toys, man. I'm gonna give me a Robert Traylor jersey and give me them Flint 13s because if you true U of M fans know that's what he was wearing when he hooped at U of M. So I'm really geek towards the 13s, man.
Are you okay with that? That's not hype beasters. You okay with that season?
Yeah, here we go.
I buy things for the nostalgia. Like when I say I'm getting this shoe, I'm getting it with the.
So you gonna get the Michigan 31?
Who? I got a pair of 31s.
You gonna get the Michigan 31?
Yeah, cause I thought I'm gonna get the Shattered Bad Boy one. I like the olive. I mean, it's like the orange.
Speaking
looks like
of which,
green,
I got
a gun bottom. I like the 31.
Is your store getting that? The ones?
The Shattered Bad Boy reverse shattered.
Yeah.
I believe. So they called me this morning. I was taking care of business.
Yeah, we're going to have a conversation.
But yeah, no,
I'm going to charge you next time.
So. I'm looking forward to 2017 altogether.
Here we go.
Oh, but I'm in really, the store the other day.
I hope they drop the Cool Grays next December.
The cashier.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the Cool Grays. Oh.
Man.
Yeah,
that was man. I was laughing at that at least 20 minutes.
So they're gonna keep retroing the same colorways then over and over.
No, I'm saying I hope they drop the cool gray 11s in the
it's always
in December. But I'm looking forward to 2017.
Like they only interview a certain type
and them scratches.
Man,
look at these guys.
Shout out to them.
Once they get that,
they make buying sneakers.
Talking about thick cashier.
Nice
they gonna get to you, man.
Dang, you just put
that's not what we're talking about. That's not what we're talking about. That's not we talking about the selection of kicks on the wall.
Nice selection.
Nice selection. Nice selection.
Yeah. I'm scared to take you to all these cities now. Because I feel like we gonna
man, I got to hang with him. Man, he know everybody, man. He come in.
I just feel like 10 years from now, we're going to get like a whole bunch of paternity tests.
Get out of here.
Cities.
I wraps it up, man. I don't know what you're talking about.
Moving forward.
Let me tell you. He walked in the store. And everybody just started twerking. So I stood there and was enjoying the show.
And then Jumpman started telling this guy that his shoes was fake. It was the most hilarious. It was.
Oh, you got to tell us the story. All right, thanks for calling in, Lionel. I don't want to have you sitting there forever. You got to tell us that story.
I don't even know where to start. It was a guy. He was there.
How did he respond?
He was in a wheelchair.
He was begging.
He was in a wheelchair.
Jumpman.
Why I laugh?
Jumpman.
Why I laugh, though?
Because you've been checking a dude in a wheelchair. He's been through enough.
He asked me the question.
Yeah, he did.
He asked me a question.
He started it.
He started it. So,
but still, even when you say he started and then you follow it up with he's in a wheelchair.
No.
It still sounds messed up.
What's wrong with you?
What is wrong with you?
No, he said that he's from the streets. That's how he started the conversation off. He said, I'm from the streets. And he said, tell me, are these, you know, real or fake? And he had on the Master 12.
Master 12.
And he said he bought them off the street. And I said, how much you buy them for, man? He said, $200 off the street.
Yeah.
That was his first mistake, was $200. His second mistake was off the street.
Yeah.
Man, I touched them boys along the side panel where the reptile skin is.
Mm-hmm.
I could damn near feel his toenail through the shoe.
Cold blood. Were they Roshi? Were they Roshi Joels?
Man, them boys, man, they turn up like elf shoes, man.
Oh wow!
And he didn't even feel bad about it. He said, "Gotta support the streets. That's where I'm from." I just left
I'm
it alone.
He has a way of turning lemons into lemonade.
Started laughing. Just said, "Okay."
Yeah. So then he just called me up. He called me out because I was in the back, and then I started walking up the aisle. And he was like, "Come feel these shoes. Come feel it." And I felt them, and
I just imagine you just start laughing.
Yeah, I started laughing. I mean, just for the scenery of it. Me and Jumpman is rubbing on this dude's shoes that's in a wheelchair in the store. It was hilarious, and they wasn't nice. They wasn't good. So
they ain't even look like top quality.
I mean, for somebody who just got though, I mean, he was real positive about it. He was like, well, I'm supporting the streets.
He's a product of the streets. He got to support the streets.
I mean, he probably bought more than, you know, just that pair. You know, that's
probably
his go-to.
He probably has a whole collection of street shoes.
Street shoes.
For gays reasons.
Hey, man. Don't buy shoes off the street.
Yeah, please don't.
Please, stay
off the
street.
That's the moral of the story.
Stay off the streets with the streets.
Because Jumpman might see you and call you out.
Yeah. I mean, he asked
wheelchair
me.
Or not.
No, but he asked me, what I'm going to do? Lie to him and say they real and then somebody else come to him? Oh, Jumpman said they was real. Then I'm...
But tune in next week when he tells the story about how he checked his kid on crutches about his shoes. all right.
They was clean, though.
Yeah.
They was clean.
They better be something. I set him up.
Man, you'd have been wrong. Man, you'd have been wrong, bro. Because I know he's going to say he don't even walk on them. It better be clean.
You know me well.
You caught yourself. I didn't say it. That was a good catch.
You see, I started doing this. I started fidgeting with the papers. Like, all right.
You wanted too bad.
I'll tell you.
Good catch.
It's very few times.
Good catch. I set you up. Good catch.
That's the alley-oop right there.
I tried, man, but you ain't ducking.
You know what? And not to derail the show, but I wanted to kind of quickly shout out James. You guys know we've been talking about him the last couple weeks. His procedure is actually either still going on or is done right now. And so, you know, I just kind of wanted to, does everybody just continue to pray for him and his family? And I appreciate all the love that, you know, people have been, I mean, we've been getting bombarded, emails, messages, people just wanting to send their prayers or wanting to send something to him to help uplift his spirits during this period of time. I specifically want to shout out 8-9 Nightwing and also the Sneaker Files podcast. Up in Vancouver, Canada. Guys, they hit me up and wanted to do something. They talked about it. They have a show coming up this Sunday, I think they're going to post. So check them out on iTunes and all their other, I don't know what other avenues their podcast comes on, but I know it's definitely on iTunes. But, you know, it's just cool to see all these people come together to support James in this time, and his family. His mother, I'm telling you, like, you don't understand the impact you have on people. Like, something as small as a pair of shoes, a poster, a shirt, a hat, whatever, like, has an impact. Like, I think she called me the other day, choked up, because he was trying on his shoes for the last time on the foot he's about to lose. Mm-hmm. And obviously, that moment hit everybody, and it just messed everybody up. And she says around that time they got another package in the mail from somebody who listened to the show, sent him something. And it made that situation a little bit better. It brought a smile to people's faces.
And that's the main thing, really, is just the first conversations.
Yeah.
And then it leading on to the gifts and the things that people are sending. But it's first the acknowledgement of what he's going through,
yep.
and giving giving him, his parents, everybody in the situation, your thoughts and prayers. And then the gifts that come along for him to have after it's done, for him to have other avenues to focus on losing a limb like that. I almost lost my leg on the force. So... Right. I was tripping out while I was in the hospital when they were thinking that they were going to have to amputate it. So right. I can imagine what he's going through with actually that happening to him and at such a young age. So it's good that everybody is reaching out to him.
Yeah, so like I said, send your prayers to him. And I even reached out to One-Legged Lester on Instagram, Army veteran who lost his leg. Still collects sneakers, doesn't let his disability hinder him from enjoying his love of sneakers. And I reached out to him and I connected those two because I felt like he would be able to relate and help him get through this. Because like, I felt like, what could I say to him? Like, me and him talk a lot, but it was like, it's easy for me to sit here and try to be positive because I'm not going through what he's going through. Mm-hmm. And I felt like, you know, if I could find somebody who's going through or went through what he went through, he would be able to better relate to him and be able to, his words would carry a lot more weight than mine. So, One-Legged Lester, he was more than willing to, talk to him and I was, you know, he got his number and I believe they talked last night. So once again, it's just cool to see the sneaker community come together and do something positive such as this. You hear all the negative stories and it's cool to hear, you know, a cool story like this where everybody shows somebody some love. So, in any event, let's keep the show moving.
It's your boy DJ Clark Kent, Brooklyn's finest, the New York Giant, the ATF General. You are listening to Sneaker Box Podcast on SneakerBarDetroit.com.
All right, news brought to you by 8-9 Manufacturing Company. 8-9 with quality meets design. Check out the sneaker-based apparel by going to the website at 89.com. Use promo code TSBP when you go to check out to save yourself an extra 20% off of your purchase. We've talked about James. I'm going to continue to talk about Nick. His mother is battling cancer. Go check out his GoFundMe account. Donate any amount, 5, 10, whatever. I mean, if you're feeling like, you know, spending a little bit more, go ahead. He's trying to get to the $100,000 mark to cover all the medical bills as his mother battles cancer. So definitely want to look out for him as well. Excuse me. We talked about this last week. I guess I'll announce it again this week. The Pinso Footwear Design Academy is teaming up for a new TV series. Pinso, 10x10 Entertainment, and Lagarde Sports are teaming up for a new unscripted competition series, which talented young designers from around the world compete to design original sneakers for a very real prize, their own signature sneaker. That will be launched and sold at one of the largest footwear retailers in the world. In each episode, the students will not only work on the grand prize shoe, but they'll also have the chance to showcase their skills by creating additional custom-made sneakers for major celebrities. These celebrities will give the designers a creative challenge and inspiration for the sneaker. Throughout the week, the star celebrity will guide the competitors as they feverishly design and build their shoe. At the end of the week, each shoe will be unveiled and judged by a panel of celebrity judges. This is scheduled for 9 weeks, and the deadline to sign up is October 16th. If you want to apply to be on the show, you can go to pensole.com, P-E-N-S-O-L-E.com. Number of things I wanted to kind of get into. Oh, this is crazy. All right, so there's a company that will let you rent Yeezys. There's other companies that let you buy and rent other
rent a center. Go get your flat screen and your Yeezys.
This man.
But it's I saw that on I think I saw it on ESPN or something, and it's a high end.
Yeah.
Come, you got to have some paper to get them.
That's yeah. crazy, man.
And
crazy.
They hand pick people too.
A week, a month, whatever, however long you want to.
Yeah,
lease
I mean,
them, rent them, whatever.
The amount of money you got to spend for the membership, I don't even know if it's worth it. You might as well just go ahead and buy the shoe on eBay.
How much is the membership?
Let me see. Let's go through it. An article written by Matt Welty for Complex. For everyone who missed on the recent Yeezy release, there's a new service that's looking to solve your problem by renting out shoes. LSWOP, short for Luxury Swap, is a new service that allows subscribers to get a pair of sneakers for 1 to 4 days for $150. There are also other plans available. Two sneakers a month for $300 and it's three sneakers a month for $450. It's slightly cheaper to become a year-long member. The company made waves when they put the new Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2 on the site. The LSWOP skews toward high-end footwear with offerings from Saint Laurent, Rick Owens, Louis Vuitton, and more. They rent shoes to people who either can't afford them, can't obtain them, or just want to make an impression. They hand-select members by asking each person questions to find out who they are. You got to take a test to get in, member?
That's oh, my crazy. God.
Normal wear.
You guys are kidding me.
Normal wear and tear is acceptable, but each sneaker that is leased out has its retail price held on the renter's credit card. So you're paying a membership, but then you also got to have enough money for the retail price to be held against your account just in case.
Just in case you messed them boys up.
But Kurt, protect your,
need insurance. Your
rental.
They're going to ask you got insurance. You need car insurance, yeah. House insurance.
But that's the only, I'm telling you, that's going to end up coming up. There's going to be some sneaker insurance coming up soon.
Yeah.
The wheels are turning in somebody's head. When the shoes are returned, the hold is lifted off the credit card, similar to renting a car. Shoes on the site are only rented out no more than three times. After that, they are sold to LSWOP's members at an 80 to 90% discounted rate. So, you may be able to shoot your shot on those Yeezys once they get rented out three or four times.
I'd rather go buy shoes from a bowling alley. Straight up.
Dang.
Honestly.
I mean, you got to think.
Got too much of your info.
That's true. And you also got to think, too, though. I mean, if you paying that much money to be a member on their site, I mean, you ain't just going to be out there bumming it up in some shoes.
He got to walk through the crib like he's Shaggy of Scooby-Doo.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Hey, Dave, can you get that piano music?
Just so you know, if you see a guy out here wearing Yeezys, he might have didn't buy them. He might be renting them.
Yeah.
So.
It is a site, that Airgoat, that you can, like, lease shoes. I remember Flight Club was going to do it, and, like, everybody, like, just attacked them for doing it. And then Airgoat, like, waited, and then with all the, I guess, the anger to die down. So now they're doing it. And it's funny because I had a guy I work with, and he was telling me about it. And he was like, man, but I don't know if I can afford those payments. I'm like, how much are they? And he was like, $30 a month. I'm like, why do you have a job and can't afford $30 a month? For? I'm like, I mean, not that I'm telling you to do it, but I mean, at least
you. Way, like, I know the GOAT sneaker app that I have, like, they connect you with other people as far as buying shoes and things on there. Mm-hmm. And then also, too, if you're like, you know, like a Supreme 5 or something like that, like a $500-$600 shoe. They'll finance it where they approve you and then you just pay like $30 a month, but you'll be paying to own the shoe.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? So,
right.
I was just about to ask if they still can afford $30.
Yeah. Not yet, but I'm going to tell you when. I want to read this story. Retailer challenges Adidas to produce more Yeezys because demand is overwhelming. An article written by Matt Hatfield for Gsnks. Eric Fagerlein, CFO and CEO of Sneakersnstuff, took out his frustrations in the wake of the latest Yeezy release on Instagram and penned an open letter challenging Adidas to do better. It read, let's get that piano going now. It's Yeezy season. I think we had more simultaneous visitors than Adidas Originals production of the Yeezy 350. I see a lot of people angry, frustrated, and sad. And I share the frustration. We do all that we can for a fair and smooth release. But since we get nowhere near the quantity to cover even 1% of the demand, people still mistrust us. I think there is a lesson to be learned here, Adidas Originals. If you continue to undercut the market this hard, people will get tired of trying. I know it is not likely that you will sell us 50,000 pairs. I'm game if you are. But you have to level the field here. Disrupting the marketplace with chaos on every release day feels very 2015. And you are the brand of the future. I am in Hers on Monday. Happy to share all info, insight, and feedback with anybody who cares. Hashtag Yeezy. Wow. That was a very emotional letter that he wrote to Adidas Original. In addition to the challenge, In addition to the challenge, Eric made his website analytics public, showing 5.5 million requests for the Yeezy Boost 350 V2 on the Sneakersnstuff website in only 24 hours.
Well, the people have spoken.
Oh, man. Is that true?
Yeah, in the morning.
I'm gonna stop at a bank for all the loans. Okay, breaking the... Well, it's not going to be breaking by the time you guys hear it, but apparently the Yeezys are dropping them. I mean, not the Yeezys. The Mags are dropping tomorrow.
Via charity auction.
Good luck with that. I'm telling you, I said this when they first announced it. Unless you got 10 grand of disposable cash just laying around, don't even waste your time.
I don't think I ever spend $10,000 on those shoes.
I don't think I ever will. Especially it's just going to be hard for me to do. Even if I was a millionaire, just coming from, like, the hood and broke and, like, now middle class, and even if I became rich, it would just still be a mentality of mine. Like, why am I spending 10 grand on this shoe again?
It'd have to be something, like, straight out of Mike's closet. Like,
but my thing is, even stuff straight out of Mike's closet, the stuff he hooped in, ain't, you know, yeah, game winners, it ain't go that much. It ain't go that much, right. So.
Man, look, like I said, don't get, I mean, especially with the power laces, there's going to be a lot of hype around that. I don't even...
When they do stuff like this, it's been like, hey, all the rich people, hey, y'all just get in line for this raffle. That's basically what they're doing.
I just feel like... I mean, granted, it's a charity auction, but I just feel like you just alienated, like, everybody. Because unless you are super rich, you are not getting your hands on that shoe. And...
I would have respect if you would have just, you know what? The original colorway, we're going to release to the public. And then the special colorway, we're going to release for charity auction.
Get a white pair.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, right. So at least that would be, you know, at least the public can get a hold of some. And then the charity auction can still do their thing.
Because you got people that, I mean, you got people that's not even sneakerheads. Like, people that just love the movie and remember that scene with him, you know, trying them on for the first time. They want a pair.
Oh, cool. Power laces.
So that's when they are unveiling to themselves that they are a hypebeast.
Yeah.
They don't know it yet. That's a defining moment when you find out to yourself that you are one. That's for them.
Yeah. Under Armour is just selling off a bunch of stock. Under Armour CEO sells off $72 million worth of stock. An article written by Rebecca Kemp for Hypebeast.com. Under Armour CEO Kevin Plank announced that he plans on selling up to 2.1 million shares valued at nearly $72 million of Class C stock in the sportswear company he founded. He entered into a prearranged stock trading plan, which will still leave him with 32 million Class C shares if the entire deal goes through. The unexpected news caused shares of Under Armour to drop 2.7%. Valued at a net worth of $3.2 billion, a majority of Kevin's wealth comes from his stocks. With overall shares dropping 4.5% in the last year, increased competition and lack of growth have put Under Armour in a tough spot. But even with the massive stock sale, Kevin will still have his Class B shares, which allow him to maintain control over a majority of the company's voting rights. So, I'm not exactly sure how that whole thing works out. I saw
them pictures of Curry 3s, and it was like, jump ship, jump, abort, abort.
Man. Speaking of rich people in shoes, it's a shoe that came out. Oh, Silicon Valley is in love with this new $95 wool sneaker. An article written by Riley Jones for Soul Collector. Venture capitalists can't get enough of Allbirds $95 wool sneakers. Wool is in right now, I guess. What's creating so much buzz around the Allbirds sneaker is the low price point, comfort of the shoe, and its availability. According to Business Insider, the cozy sneakers have developed quite a following in Silicon Valley, with Allbirds raking in $2.2 million in seed round funding. In fact, Business Insider goes as far as to predict that Allbirds could soon join the hoodie and t-shirt as part of the infamous startup uniform. The Allbirds wool runners come in a variety of colors, including a few limited edition versions, and you can find them at allbirds.com. I doubt they're going to have any of my size, so I'm just not even going to look. That's enough of news this week. Gavin.
Yes.
You got any shoes for us this week?
Yes, I do.
All right, eBay sneaker deals with Gsnks.
Yes, I do.
Brought to you by Gsnks 89, clothing brand. If you're looking to dress fly and show off your love of sneakers, head to a store located at 25538 5 Mile Road in Redford, Michigan, or you can go to gsnks89.net.
Good job. That was great. Just to let you know. Okay, guys, if you want to get nicely fitted,
on a budget, I got some deals for you. First up, we got Nike LeBron 10 PS Elite, the white, black, and gold colorway, size 8.5. These are on eBay right now for $150. $150, and you know that Elite price tag is way up there, and it's size 8.5. And next we got, oh, these just came out too. We got Kobe 11 Low 3D. They're on there right now for $100, size 10. So if you can search that. And then we got a championship and cigar pack from the Retro 7s.
Mm-hmm.
For under $500. It's $497, and you know you got to pay the shipping. But, you know, each one of those retail for $250, so that's not a bad deal to get both of them for retail price. And they are a size 11. And then Nike Lab Air Force One Low, size 9. And, you know, the Labs are the premium Air Force One, the premium Air Force One. They online right now for $119 with the best offer option. So you can get fitted. Then we got a KD. I tried to versatile it this time. Try to give you guys.
Yeah.
I did LeBron.
Get the critics what they want.
I did LeBron's. I did Kobe's. Air Force Ones. We did Jordan. And now we got a KD. We got a what the KD 6.
You hear that, Caesar?
What's that?
I did the diversity this time.
My bad. I took a nap while you was talking. Yeah. I dozed off. What happened, man?
Just the hate is real.
Our team is diverse.
The hate is real,
so,
man.
So, you know, we brought in some shoes other than Jordan's. J-O-R-D-A-N.
So we got a What the KD 6. Jordan. This one is pre-owned, size 9.5. It's online right on eBay right now for $150 with the best offer option. So you probably can get a little cheaper than that, size 9.5. And this one is pre-owned, but it looks damn good.
Probably I have to say, like, is it from the same seller as last week? Because that dude was underselling himself. But I'm sure, had he not said that they were used, you wouldn't
know.
But
you got to think, on eBay, man. You it's a lot of deals on there. It's
you got to look.
It's a lot of deals on there. You got so many people just trying to get cash today.
Yeah.
You know? I got a couple pair of nice shoes.
People just trying to get cash today. Yep. Like, they need it today.
They pay them bill.
Yeah. So, they know trying to get it sold.
Like, I got those Pagali Dunks for, like, $120.
Right.
And I'm like, I don't know if they knew what they had, or like you said, they were just trying to get
people
some good cash.
People getting cash, and they know they the kicks in that closet to bring some money in real quick.
That's a gentleman I follow on Instagram. His name is StayPuft76. He goes to outlets and does a lot of shopping and sneaker deals. Mm-hmm. It's Nike outlet in Jackson, New Jersey. They got the Dunk From Above Retro 4s. And the L.A. Retro 10 City Packs for $129. I mean, they got a whole bunch of them. And they got the Retro 17 Chicago Bulls when you scored a 30,000 point. They got those for $199. He found a pair of Dornbecker LeBron 13s at Marshalls for $99. He found a pair of Air Trainers All Red for $46 at Marshalls. Find a pair of Black History LeBron 13s. The tag says past season on Marshalls. $39. Air Bacons, the Golden State colorway, $49 at Marshalls. Air Max Charles Barkley's for $79. And some New Balances, the 580s, like in almost like the Mariners colorway, $49. And the Black History Huaraches at Ross for $49.
That's what's up. So, if those are any of you guys' sizes and you live in either that area or you have access to eBay, which most people do. Oh, man, he's showing me this meme of the Panthers defense. But, yeah, go ahead and shoot your shots and go ahead and get them shoes. this meme is horrible.
The longest yard.
That meme is horrible. Y'all ain't gonna pick in the Panthers like that this year.
Uniform color,
man. He looking terrible. I think ever since he said that race comment, like there's no such thing as racism.
Well, I tell you what, the next time he by the goal line, he gonna take the ball in without being lackadaisical. The way the hit got put on him
yeah,
only defense I got from him this year is that a lot of them after when he throw the balls on late hits, they ain't been calling. A lot of them have been head-to-head, which ain't cool. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because you can't even touch Tom Brady's socks and they'll throw a flag. You know what I'm saying? Right. I'd be looking like, are you serious, bro? He sidestepped on it. He'd be like, Tom Brady be like this, and they throw the flag, and this man getting head-butted. But so outside of that, as far as his performance and his team performance, they got
to
do better.
They did the same thing to Vic. Like, they just started.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
when he was his last year in Philly, yeah, with that weak turbo online, it's like, it make you pay for being a black quarterback.
All types of ways. I remember one time, there was a late hit out of bounds and they didn't call it. I'm like, wow. All right.
They just trying to get rid of the black quarterbacks. Just... I feel like they presidents. When a black quarterback make an NFL, they be like shrieking. Like, we got to get him out of here.
Man.
I mean, but then Ryan Tannehill and all the other weak quarterbacks, Gabbert could throw 6 picks in one game and he'll still have his job.
Yeah, I don't know, man. That's a whole nother podcast right there. I wanted to, like I mentioned James earlier, and we got him on the phone. Not James, but we got Daniel Lister, one-legged Lister. He was more than willing to talk to me, and he was more than willing to talk to James and kind of, try to relate to him in his situation. Daniel?
Yo, what's going on?
What's
good morning,
up, man? What's up?
Afternoon. That's afternoon now.
Yeah. First of all, let me just say, man, you get all of our respect just from serving in the military, and fighting and defending for this country. You lost your leg, I believe.
I did.
In the military.
Afghanistan.
Yeah.
It's a weird country. You know, you go there with 2 legs, you come home with 1. It's weird, man. It's weird.
That's
a joke. It's cool. I don't laugh. It's fine.
No, I mean, that's the thing I realized about you when I talked to you is that most people be bitter or they have some type of resentment. You seem to have, like, come to grips with what the situation is, and you are just, like, living life.
Right. Like, so, this, like, the loss of my limb has kind of, it set me and my family up for success. It's a choice that I wouldn't have made.
Right.
You know, like, let me get this leg up right quick. but it's a choice that I can live with because it set my family. I was able to retire. You know, I'm a single parent.
Right.
You know, and that's really my main job in life. You know, I go to school and stuff, but, mainly my main job is to ensure that my kids, have what it takes to live in today's. It ain't my job to be their friend, to buy them stuff, to make sure their phones work. It's to make sure that they are ready to become adults when that time to happen.
Right.
You know, and it's losing my limb, well, at the time, seemed like a curse, seemed like the worst thing that could ever happen to me, ultimately ended up becoming one of the best things that's ever happened in my life. It opened doors for me. It, I got to meet some cool people and be a part of some cool things.
Right.
So I can look at it as a blessing. I'm alive, and that's the biggest thing is I'm still here.
Right.
I'm still here.
Yeah, you were just recently at the Falcons game yesterday, right?
I was the hometown hero at the Falcons game.
Nice.
Which is really cool. And I got to watch that. I heard y'all talking about that hit that Cam took.
Oh.
Now, I got love for Cam because, he's from Atlanta. He's a East Point native. But I was kind of excited to see him get hit because he be saying some crazy things. He says crazy things on television because he doesn't see certain aspects of the reality of the black community. So,
right.
It's not that he doesn't believe that racism, it's that he is immune to it. Kind of like how OJ.
One thing real quick, man. I will go against that, but you got to remember, look what they did to him his last year at Armour.
Okay,
They reminded him very much so that he was black. And what his.
Right.
Yeah, they reminded him very much so. So.
But I will say, it's funny, like, it's eerie the parallels between him and OJ. Like, not to say he's going to go murder anybody, but still.
Yeah, I don't think Cam's going to murder anybody. I think, I think he's comfortable and likes where he's at.
You're right.
The state or whatever, says that OJ didn't murder no one. So, I'm going to go with what they say.
Yeah, okay.
But. That's neither here nor there.
Either, I agree with you. Either he did it or he knew who did it. But that's another
right.
subject.
right. But, he can't. I'm sorry, I get caught up on sports. But, I personally like seeing Cam take that hit. Was it a solid hit? Should there have been a flag thrown? Yeah. But was there, he took it, and the thing is, the thing I like about Cam is he took it like a champ,
Right.
He wasn't complaining. There was no whining. You know, and he was even mad that he was getting put into protocol. You know, and that, you know, that's a team player right there. Like, he's willing to sacrifice maybe a couple years of his life to maintain the football game. And I like that. I can respect that about it.
Right.
That's a totally another topic, my bad.
No, you're good, man. You're good. Love it. But so I was, you know, obviously we had the situation with James. He's actually, I tried texting his mother. She's not responding. So I'm guessing that, you know, this procedure is still going on.
Right.
And he, you know, leading up to this morning, he was getting, I guess the reality was setting in, and you could tell he was, not panicking, but like getting more and more nervous as, you know, it drew closer. And like I said, like, I knew that, you know, it's easy for me to sit here and try to talk all this positivity because I'm not in his position. And so, right. That's why I reached out to you. And like, the one thing I appreciate about you is one, like I said before, is the fact that you didn't let your disability like stop you. Like, a lot of people would just be like embarrassed or just like want to just shy away from it. Like, you acknowledged it. Like, you are front and center about it. Like, there's pictures of you with your like prosthetic on with your sneakers. And you're like, I'm going to wear these. And
I like to make it a center point, you know, because you don't see it. And that's the thing, is you just don't see stuff like that.
Right.
Like, people try to hide it. People try to wear pants all the time. Like, I like to put my prosthetic, like, I like my favorite pictures that I like to, I'm tooting my own horn and stuff, but, you know, my favorite pictures that I take are usually the ones where I can, like, use my prosthetic in, like a perception type of way. Like, put the prosthetic up front, and then it looks like I'm kind of leaning on it or sitting in it or,
right.
You know, like, because to me, it's not a handicap, you know, like, that prosthetic limb allows me to walk.
Right.
You know, I can run. I've ran, you know, five miles and stuff. Like I know that ain't much, but for a one-legged dude to run 5 miles, that's some intense stuff. That's all I'm saying.
Right.
You know, and I know, guys, I'm trying to hold this mic out so that my beard's not covering all this junk up. But I know guys that have lost legs and arms that do marathons.
Wow.
You know, so, you know, it's not the end of, like, when it first happens, you feel like, oh, my life is done. I'm never going to walk again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I told you about this yesterday is when I was at Walter Reed. And for those who don't know, Walter Reed is a military hospital where they send soldiers from the East Coast, severely wounded soldiers from the East Coast. They send them there for rehabilitation.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they will. I was on all these machines, you know, like I had all these wound vacs and stuff, you know, and my right leg was ripped from my ankle to my hip. Both of my fib were broke. My knee had to be completely rebuilt.
Oh.
And my femur was broken. I had to have 3 pins in it. And the hip was cracked.
Damn.
So they had to, I had to go through 17 surgeries just to rebuild my right leg. You know, and they were going to take it. They were going to chop it off at the hip. And I was like, no, can we not? Can we not do that? can we try something else?
They're like,
yeah, we could try it, but it's a long process and a lot of surgeries and nothing's guaranteed but pain.
Wow.
You know? And I was like, well, I'll try that. Because, you know, like, if you lose half of your hip, you're sitting in a bucket. You know,
right?
And my hat's off to those those ladies and gentlemen who are hip dysarthric,
right?
Because they're in a bucket and they're having to throw their whole abdominal to move forward and to walk. But the people walk with that amputation, and you know, those people to me are, you know, beasts. They're just raw beast mode.
Right.
But so I had to go through a whole bunch of surgeries to do that, just to maintain this leg. So anyway, they take me down to the military amputee training center, my hospital bed, all my cords and cables, you know, and they're like, I'm like, oh, my life's over. I'm never going to walk again. And they're like, it's really not that bad. You know, it's not that bad, you know? So they wheel me into this room, and this Marine who lost all 4, so he lost both legs and both arms in Iraq, you know, one of the first to ever make it back after losing all 4 in combat. So it's not like he lost 4 in the hospital. He lost them in country, you know? And I wish I could remember that guy's name, but so he came walking up to my bed as they wheeled me down there, you know, missing just below my knee. And he's like, "Hey man, are you ready to start working yet?" You know, and he's got this like fake arm on, holding a water bottle and like spinning it, like showing off, like, "Look what I can do." You know? And you know, his other arm was a cane as he was walking up. And you know, I could not get out of that hospital bed fast enough after that. You know, because for me, it was just like, well, if he can do it, you know, so can I.
Right.
You know, I can get up and do this.
And that's what I wanted for James. I wanted like that same impact. I wanted him to talk to somebody who was. Who had been through what he's going through right now, and to be able to, you know, talk to somebody, like I said, relate. I mean, and it was just cool. Like, I mean, you responded quickly. Like, I didn't even have to, like, sell it to you. You were just like, "Yeah, give me his number." And I'm just like, wow.
No, because that's where it matters. That's where it matters. Like, if I can be a voice for those who are afraid to speak, who are ashamed of their prosthetics, you know,
mm-hmm.
That's a blessing. That's something I get to do today. It's something I've been blessed with through this injury. You know, that's something, and I'm more than willing to do anything like that, anything at all.
Right.
You know,
I'm mad that we missed you at SneakerCon Atlanta because you told me you were down there. I'm mad we missed you.
Oh man, I was mad hype in that place. You know, like,
did you catch the game?
I don't really watch YouTube like that, so like I didn't know like. I walked past some people and like, you know, some of the dudes I was with, they were tripping and I was like, I don't know who that is, you know. Like, if you're on Instagram, I generally know who you are.
Right.
If you're on YouTube and you talk about, I mean, like, you know, I ain't trying to hate on the YouTube sneaker game, but I don't really know how it works.
Right.
You know, like, are you just gonna show me the shoe? Like, I don't know. I sound like I'm hating, but I ain't trying to hate.
No. I mean, no. You like you are matter of factly.
Like, I just don't, you know, there's a couple guys on there that I watch, like OT Dub and stuff, because he cracks me up.
Right.
But you know, I didn't know any of those people. They're like, "Oh, you need to go follow Quasomar or something like that." And I was like, okay. Because apparently I walked past him, and he said, "What's up?" And I didn't know who he was, and apparently that was a big deal.
Right.
but, you know, since then, I've looked him up, and apparently he's got a lot of followers. He's doing his thing, and, you know, that's real exciting.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, I heard the game. I thought like some NBA players was over there, the way people was cheering. I mean, it was rowdy.
Yeah, it was really, yeah. I mean, you had like everybody named Mama over there.
Yeah, it was nice.
But definitely.
Yeah, Mike Rich, or, you know, like Rich Kick.
Yeah.
Like, you know, he's from Atlanta. So, I mean, like, I try to keep up with the Atlanta sneakerheads, you know, because where I'm from matters to me, you know. Cause
right.
I try to rep where I'm from, so. You know, him and T Ward, I got to chop it up with those cats for a minute. And that was pretty cool.
Right.
But, you know, for me, it was meeting the other people. Because I got, like, kids that would come up to me, like, want to take pictures with me and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And that's real foreign to me. Like, I was like, cool, yeah, I mean, let's take a picture. I'll take a picture, too. I don't know who you are, but, yeah, let's do this.
All right.
You know, I was super excited about it. Like, I was just excited to be there. Like, I got to talk to you yesterday. I was saying, like, just don't spend $1,000. That's all.
Right.
Just don't spend more than $1,000. That's all I got to do today is just not spend more than a G and I'll be all right.
Did you stay under a G?
Yeah. I mean, I ended up spending like $400. I ended up getting the Slam Dunk Sixes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man. That still hurts me to this day that I can't get those.
Right. And, you know, I paid for $450 ain't bad for them, I feel.
No.
You know what I mean? Like, since when they originally dropped, they was $250. You know, so. I can rock out on some $450, like I can deal with that, like $200,
no,
you know,
I
for a finder fee,
right?
You know, which I'm cool with. I can deal with that,
right?
You know, but I got to meet like the guys at TV Watches because, you know, they gave me, you know, they're like, "Hey, let's work together." I'm like, "Cool, let's do that." And I got to meet up with them, and those cats are hard working. I don't know if y'all really talked to those guys or
I haven't talked to them. JB,
yeah, I got watches from them before.
Yeah, JB. Yeah. We got JumpmanBostic here.
Them boys was working. Yeah. They drove 13 hours set up and then had to drive 13 hours back to NYC. I'm like, y'all putting it in today. Like, y'all doing that. Like, do your thing. You know, but back to the young man, you know, I really hope to reach out. I'm like, I got his mama's number, you know, and I hope to. I was going to call him today, but I got kind of caught up. I got some new shelves. I'm trying to get all my kicks off the floor because my towers are starting to piss me. Or, excuse me. My towers are starting to, like, lean a bit and, like, bend the boxes. And I like the boxes just as much as I like the shoes.
Right. Oh, you don't have to censor yourself. Trust me. I've said enough just today.
Oh, like, I'm over here struggling like I'm on some, you know, like I
Yeah, trust me.
I got a mouth, you know, so I have a tendency to like pop off. So I'm just trying to, you know, I'm trying to do some spiritual stuff over here. Don't give me an out. Don't give me an out because it'll be a problem.
Nah, you're in good company over here.
Yeah, so yeah, I'm trying to make room because I pretty much got these ones that are about to drop the away, the shadow backboards away. I got them unlocked, so yeah, I'm excited about those.
That's what's up.
But I'm hearing that the orange leather is subpar. But you know, I feel like people compare everything to shattered backboards.
Right.
Like, and if it's not shattered backboards, they're just like upset about it. You know.
Yeah.
Like,
I kind of feel.
I feel like they do that because for the longest, the Jordan 1 material was terrible, as far as on the retro side. So when they give you some quality one, you fiend it for you, then they snatch it away. You got to withdraw. So I think that's why people act like that towards them.
Right. But they also compare every single Jordan 1 release to that shoe.
The shattered backboard, you know, wasn't the only one with the best set. The shattered backboard was just over the top a little bit. You know, it was just like
right,
the next level.
Right, yeah, they had it all over.
Because the Chicago's had some dope leather on them. The Powder Blues had some dope leather on them. So they were, all those were soft.
The Lettermans,
yeah, were
soft. The Midnight Navies was dope. So,
yeah, I love both of those. And the people slept on those.
Yeah,
hard.
And Cyber Mondays was incredible.
I'm gonna tell you the most slept on one though. It had the best quality before they caught themselves doing the whole remaster series. Is the Laneys?
Hell yeah!
Right?
Hell
the
yeah!
The Laneys were ridiculous.
The Laneys was crazy.
The blue, blue on there, the
like
color was red.
After a while, though, the yellow leather was fine, but like when we had them in our store, the blue leather suede.
I almost forgot about the Laneys. Yeah. That yellow leather was up there, maybe a step
legit
under shattered backboard. It was, and that suede was butter.
Mm-hmm.
They went on sale for $40 at Villa. Mm.
Wow, people slept the nose.
I miss those. I'm so sad.
Yeah,
I look at my boxes, just upset that particular pair is not in my stack of ones. You know.
Like, you didn't get those?
No. No, because at the time, like, so, all right, I have a thing about certain shoes, right? Because my feet are different, right? I have a skinny fake foot that doesn't bend, right?
And why you say it like that?
Because that's what it is. It's a skinny-ass fake foot. Like, it don't bend. You know, there's no, it's like a mannequin, right?
Right.
And then I got a wide-ass real foot that wants to flatten the sides of the shoe out. Cause I'm a big boy. I'm 6'2", 260 pounds. I'd be fucking up some size 11.
Right.
Excuse me. You gave me an out. Now,
do what you do, man. Trust me. I say worse.
So, you know, with one, you know, I have to wear them sparingly because it's the same way with sixes, because the way sixes get that crease, like, right on that side panel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like on the Carmine, that red, not the toe, but the one that the red, like right beside, like where your pinky toe would be.
Yeah.
You get this weird crease, right? So on my right foot, I don't get that crease because my foot's wide and it kind of fills the shoe out. But on my left foot, the foot's not that wide. And I got to wear like 8 pairs of socks on that one foot just to kind of stretch it out.
Right.
But still, so once though, I had this thing where they don't quite bend the same way.
Right.
So I had this thing about it. And at the time, I didn't really have as many ones as I have now. And now I have a little bit more of a rotation, so I never really kind of smash my shoes, you know?
Right.
I know that's a really long, convoluted story to explain my butt hurt on why I didn't get those Laney ones. But, you know, truth be told, I just missed out on them, you know?
Honestly, too, I probably would have missed out on them, too. I just so happened to see them go for like $100. And I just said, why not? And I'm happy I got them because they, nice.
And that's kind of how I feel, you know, like about the Lettermans. Like, you know, people slept on the Lettermans super hard, but that leather is like the same as the Cyber Monday. It's like I said, it's not quite that tumble butter stuff.
Yeah.
You know, but it's that, like, it's dope. Like in comparison to like the rare air ones that drop, or the like the leather on the hair ones that dropped
right
last year. You know, like that's that hard, almost plastic feeling leather.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I they slept on them. You know, it's the same leather that's on the quarter panels, like the where the swoosh is at, like underneath the swoosh on the bread.
Yeah,
it's that same leather, that soft. Like it ain't the tumbled stuff that's on the check or on the collar, but I got a thing about one. That's my thing right now is I'm kind of stuck on some ones. You know, I'm over here like researching some Royals, and they want to charge me $500 for some Royals. I'm like, I'll just
January. Then they come on.
Yeah, they come back out
in January.
Right. Yeah, and everything's coming back out. And that's the cool part is they're redropping the whole OG colorway.
Yep.
From 2017 to, like, was it early 2018?
Yep.
Like, and I don't know about y'all, but, like, I'm really excited about that.
Yeah, with better materials. So, yeah, I'm just going to
wait. Right. You know, and they got the whole metallic pack. Now, you know, some of those metallic colors are a bit whack, you know. Like, I'm not a fan of, like, that metallic green color. But, you know, I got a thing that also, like, if I have one, I kind of need all of the OG colorways. Yeah. You know? So that's really what breaking my wallet.
The only two ones I'm really waiting for now, outside of, you know, Royal and the Shadows, is if they ever bring back that orange, the white and orange joints. They like the white and the navy blues, but the blue was orange. And the black and gold joints. If they ever bring those back out.
They got to get them blue and gold ones done.
Yeah.
The Mellows?
No, not the Mellows. The like there was all patent leather.
Oh,
with the gold swoosh.
Yeah. Those are super dope. But see, and again, I probably would pass on those just because I like the way ones look like when you rock them, you mm-hmm. know, like without the sneaker shields, like, you know, like just ones, right? Like just creased up, beat up, loved ones. I like that. I like the way that looks.
Right.
But patent leather, on the other hand, have y'all ever seen a pair of, like, rocked out three, like, the green bean fives?
The green bean fives, yeah.
Like, so when people just wear them to death, they just turn them into beaters. You know how deep those creases are on the toe box?
Yeah.
That's my fear for any patent leather one, is that it's just going to be, like, a super creased, like, amazing creases everywhere, you know?
Right.
And then on my left foot, it's just going to be this pristine shoe because it's fake and it's, you know, don't bend, you know. So right. I would pass on those. But I like the red metallics that are supposed to be coming out, the purple metallics that are supposed to be coming out. They're supposed to do that whole metallic pack, and I'm really excited about that.
Right.
Yeah. And then.
Real quick, are you going to try to reach out to James today or I mean,
he's probably
let him rest today. Yeah.
Right. If he's in surgery today, he's going to spend most of his day waxed out. You know, they're going to keep him. So my plan was to reach out to the mother today because I'm sure she's going to have a heck of a day.
Yeah.
So that's my plan is to reach out to her.
Okay.
And try to schedule something because that's really, you know, she's going to need help right now because it's hard for her. Like, what she's going to realize is she's going to go to wash his socks. And she's going to go looking for a pair of socks and only find one.
Right.
You know, and that's gonna hurt her. I remember my stepmom, you know, when she was doing my laundry, that kind of threw her for a loop, and she wasn't really prepared for that, you know. And, you know, so she's going to need some support just as much as he will need that support because she's going to try to deal with her son. And it's really kind of a deal that affects everyone in the family unit. You know, it's not just a, you know, it's a whole deal, especially at the beginning, like the first 3 months.
Uh-huh.
The first 3 months are brutal. You're dealing with phantom pain. You're dealing with stitches. You're dealing with infection and changing of bandages. And, you know, it can be real encompassing for everyone around you.
Right.
You know?
But, I'm definitely happy that, you know, you stepped up and you're willing to do all this for James. And, definitely keep us posted, not only with, you know, your interaction with James, but also, you know, whatever you got going on, definitely keep in touch with us. We definitely appreciate you being on the show today.
Oh, awesome. Thanks for having me. I just had a really good time.
All right, man. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Take care, man.
Nice to meet you, bro.
Yep.
All right, brother.
Yep.
Y'all be good.
Yes, sir. All right, that was Daniel Lister. You can follow him on Instagram at OneLeggedLister. Yeah, so shout out to James, man. Just prayers, man. Just I don't know, man. I don't even know how to follow that up. Let's just go. We'll keep it moving. If you want to make sure your shoes look just as fresh as when they came out the box, practice safe stunting and go to creptprotect.com and get your shoes some protection. You know, I was going to try to talk to the founder of Perp Me. There was a real good story about a kid that gave his shoes to a homeless man. And actually, he's changed his life around. I guess he was a troubled kid, and he got involved with his organization and got his life around. And now, I was talking to him earlier today. He's actually got scholarships and is checking out schools today. So
that's what's up.
Yeah. So we're going to talk to them next week because we're kind of running out of time. Guru, let's get outside the box with the shoe guru.
Well, kind of basically going back to touch on what we did for the for these releases, the Puma Clyde Wraith Pack. I think how they executed that one was dope, to kind of take the luxury of the Wraith from the materials and the sleekness of the car and kind of incorporating the shoe. Another shoe that I like is a New Balance 599, the Hyper Blue with the teal. I think those are dope. A lot of things went under the radar. This year was more heavy of the big dudes. You know, the Jordans, of course, took over this release. Of course, the Retro 12 and the OVOs. The Aces one kind of went underneath the radar. But heading to next week, say y'all opinion, what y'all think about the Teyana Taylor's Fire and Ice?
That's going to be – I'm wanting to see the not chaos, but I just want to see the level of hype.
I actually seen it. I actually seen it. Held the shoe. Mm-hmm. It's a nice shoe.
I wish, is that upper suede or?
Yeah, it's suede.
I wish it was leather.
It's suede.
Because they look like the original pictures were leather.
Toe is leather.
Yeah, I know, but it looked like in the original pictures, and maybe it was just the lighting that it looked like the entire upper was leather.
I seen that they're coming in grade school. On my release date calendar said men's. I seen another one say women's. Which size did you hold? Was it a women's or a men's or?
It was a small size. It was like at least a size 8 or smaller. So okay. It wasn't a men's size that they put in my hand.
If they come in men's sizes, I mean, yeah.
I saw a couple of people on eBay selling. They got extended sizes, so you can buy, like, you know how you did with the Jordans back in the day? If you were 11 and a half, you bought the 13 in women's or whatever. So right. I think they're doing them like that.
That's a good point. The one that he did give me was...
I don't think they're going to make them in a 16 and a half, 17 before you, bro.
They're not. I'm not going to get my hopes up. I did for like that first week when they first dropped the picture, and then I was just kind of like, nah, man.
Dream crush.
Yeah.
That was 17. Yeah. That was 17 and a half, baby.
Nope. I mean, I don't wear 17, but yeah.
I'm saying it's a woman's shoe season, so you're going
to. That was 17 and a half, baby.
Yeah. And it's like one of my favorite, like, I mean, I like all red shoes. And then you're going to have an all red question, like one of my favorite silhouettes.
Hey, Jumpman, grab that tissue.
So, yeah, I'm a little hurt about that. I don't know, maybe if I clip my toenail, maybe I can fit a size 13, maybe. Asshole.
Get you right.
Yeah,
there,
it's a killer, man.
That toenail, that's a different.
How many socks you done killed?
Man, too many to count.
The toenail.
I'm just gonna run with it. I'm just gonna, you know, as soon as the show's over, I'm gonna invest in a toenail clipper and spend the next hour before work trying to undo some damage.
I can fit this 13, baby.
Man, so I actually wear a 13 this whole time. Like, I'm buying only size 15s. It's crazy. I hate you. Why did I invite you?
You
to the
brought
show?
The toenail up, man. I ain't what
you brought the toenail up
just
asshole.
Now. Just now.
No, last week. At this point, I'm like, you know, I'm about to just run.
That's
with
because you
like,
was talking about me last week. You was on my head, and I had to defend myself. So man. On the fly, on the fly.
Well, so if you can't catch those, the Lening ways will be waiting on you. Pretty sure the China people look out for you in size 15 as well. Next week.
I don't think anybody over there wears size 15.
Nobody.
I don't know.
You know they have to come together and make things happen. So I'm pretty sure they get you a 15 together. They're like, I ain't gonna do it.
That's your teammate now.
It wasn't about him.
It was a joke about them making it together. But I like eating Chinese food, so I ain't gonna say nothing about the good old people in China.
I'm telling you. We offended everybody today. Like,
I got a question for you.
What's that?
The Jordan brand chairman, the Westbrook, please explain to me why that shoe's so terrible.
Come on, I want to hear Jordan,
the last year's and then this year's.
This is even worse.
Jordan brand gives you your own shoe and you pick the lifestyle brand part. You know what I'm saying? So that's, you could have had a gym shoe and then say, hey, I want to make a lifestyle shoe. It would have been dope if he had a shoe for the during the season. And then in the off season, he could have dropped like the shoe that he got now.
He seems content wearing like retros though, or whatever new Jordan is coming out. Yeah,
but I'm just saying though, they gave you your own shoe, and that's what you.
You would think. I know. I would.
But I was saying, what you judge?
But how?
And especially his lifestyle is not one to buy into.
Yeah,
so I just want to think. You just made me think about the Westbrook shoe. Period.
I say nothing of it.
He passed the rock. Like, assist,
I personally
assist.
Don't like him. Yeah. How much decision did he have in the shoe?
You could tell he has a lot of really.
On that one, he had a lot of.
You could tell there's a lot of his influence on that shoe.
For him to choose something like that is just his personality, and I guess.
I don't know, but that ain't nobody.
It's not something I would buy. I'm not saying I love every single shoe that they
have. You see that video of him dancing?
Yes.
I'm glad I didn't.
But you did?
I haven't.
The
I don't
shoe
think I want
in the
to.
Video goes.
I don't have
hand
one
hand
Westbrook
hand.
Shoe. I don't have one.
They went on sale for like $69, $59, and that's when everybody started buying them. We had the light bone color, the navy, the black and infrared, and then it was one more of the color. But yes, it was just, I don't know. Then the last year ones had like, a Vans bottom with the Retro 11.
That's what they look like to me.
Part, and then up the, it just looked like.
They weren't. You know what? Last year's, it's not like it was, because like you said, it looked like Vans. Or it looked like some type of like old school basic sneaker, like a 2016 version of a PF Flyer or something. I don't know, but like so, it wasn't like the most atrocious. It was just like, okay, you got your own shoe, and this is what you come up with. And then to see him take it a step, like I didn't think he could go any deeper than that. Like I thought you was at ground level. Like he pulled out a shovel. It was like I'm going lower.
Damn.
And, like,
he like, yeah, he every he hit every rock bottom one, and chills it does his way get lower. Worse. He gonna be at the core of Earth in a minute.
I'm telling you, yeah, he's gonna really be in China
is,
somewhere.
Every year is really getting worse.
There's gonna be a tunnel from Oklahoma City to China,
and
through the center of the Earth by the time he's through digging.
And from what I hear, Jumpman and Jordan Brand, they behind it. Like,
I mean, he balling. I mean, I guess you got no choice, but man, that shit.
I think they took it. That was a trade off. Like, we'll give you your own shoe to keep you happy because we don't need somebody. To push this 31.
Yeah, he be dunking on
yeah.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? He so that's what it is.
I can't stand that shit. Like I said, I didn't think you'd go any
the
worse.
Westbrook
than that.
Or the 31, huh? You just...
I'd rather the 31 than the Westbrook. Like, it's not even a question. Especially that camo colorway that he came out with. I guess that's going to be the first colorway he comes out. Camo ain't meant to go on everything, man. Like, people throwing camo on everything, like, that makes it look better. It actually makes it look worse. In any event, that is all you have for us today?
Yeah. It's a little light as far as outside the Nike Jordan box, though. All
right.
Hey, y'all see the 13 supposed to come with that OG box?
The silver box?
With the little engraved circle with
the
little red
Jumpman.
Yeah. That's going to be crazy.
All right.
Like how they did with the 12.
They're going to bring back the face box?
I can remember vividly a year ago, I said that they should, when they start retroing, they should give
the
you
black
the
box
whole,
with the silver face on the top.
Mm-hmm. I think they should bring back the boxes with the shoes to give you that whole feeling. I said that a year ago. So anytime people know Beaverton, you can give me my credit. You know,
they've been doing that with the fives, the sixes, the ones.
Well, you got to start ones, threes, fives, sixes.
I saw the Virtual 11 box this year is going to be pretty interesting. Not to have a slide out one, but the.
Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah.
Yeah.
But, as of somebody working in a shoe store, please, Adidas, make your boxes better. I'm tired of putting your boxes up and they slide and they fall and you just stack three boxes on top of each other and they fall. Please get your boxes together. Y'all made enough money off Kanye and Ultra Boosts. Fix your boxes. That's all I got to say. Go ahead.
Now that we got that out the way.
Message.
Right.
Barry White Ranger here. You all know that I entertain a great deal. And when I'm out and trying to make my best impression, my ensemble is never complete without a really great pair of sneaks. Like me, you can keep your kicks in the best shape possible, simply with Crep. Just a spray or two of Crep, a quick brushing, and voila, yeah, that was French. And my sneaks are protected from spaghetti, or a fine bottle of Chianti, or even a splash of mud while I help my special lady out of her chariot as we make our way back to my humble abode. You may not entertain as much as I have the opportunity to, but when you do, make sure that what you got on your feet looks its best, with crepe. Take it from Barry White Ranger. You won't be sorry, and neither will she.
Yo, what's good? This is Bullet RC, and you're listening to the number one sneaker show, the Sneaker Boss Podcast, on SneakerBarDetroit.com.
Man, you know what? I honestly want to do a video of that commercial. Like, I'm just like, as I'm listening to it, I'm just thinking, like, man, this would be dope for like White Ranger. Miss him. He'll be back next week, though, right? All right. Shout out to Dave, though. Dave's been holding it down for us the last three episodes.
Damn,
baby. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to Dave.
I'm Eric's bitch.
No. You own this ass!
All right, so Eric's bitch has been running the show on the sound side, a.k.a. Phone Slut. Like, I the last 3 weeks, I look over and, like, I'm, like, looking at the callers list.
He got to get
and
the
I look
part.
Like Phone Slut. Like,
he got to get the part where he be like, no, I'm not.
Right, no, right. Yes, you are.
You are my bitch.
That is the best part of that movie.
That is.
The other guys. No, not the other guys. The,
it's the, 22 Jump Street.
22 Jump Street, yes.
You got it. You guys got to get
me
the fuck
out of
here.
He was all in it last night. Like, they turned his dick into a vagina.
You guys got to get me the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
You never seen 22 Jump Street?
Yeah, I seen it, but man.
People have seen it. Like, so I mean, I'm just restating what they already seen. By far, one of the funniest parts of that movie, though. Okay. So we did the Kith store, which had like I'm telling you, like umpteen negative reviews, right? So I just started looking at like different like stores. So there's one from like Wish in Atlanta, the Trophy Room. Some guy, yeah, like I read the Trophy Room opened like when, like this summer,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. And like this one guy had like, this is from the opening day. So
he
yeah,
was expecting
I the best
Jordan
for
to be
oh
in
my
there.
God, yeah, he expected a lot. I'm telling you, he. I'm telling you, if there was like a sneaker Malcolm X, this would be the guy. Like, you know, he's just like we didn't land on Plymouth Rock. Like, he'd been bamboozled, ran amok, led astray. And then we got one for Flight Club. Like, trust me, you know what? Next week is going to be like all Flight Club because Flight Club got a million negative reviews too. But let's start off with Wish. Yep, one star sneaker store reviews brought to you by Sneaker Legends, Metro Detroit's newest sneaker spot. Missed out on your favorite release? No problem. Head down to the store located at 1033 Howard Street in Dearborn, Michigan. If you can't make it to the store, then head to their website at sneakerlegends.com. Is that can number three?
Yeah, we are.
Man. All right, so you got a Wish on Moreland Ave in Atlanta, Georgia. All right. No customer service at all. I will never come back or refer anyone to stop here. I just went in this store, and I guess I didn't look like the normal, trendy Atlanta dude because no one, and they spelled no one, K-N-O-W-O-N-E, because no, no,
because, not one.
No, right, because no one asked to help me but this one guy, which me and my girl appreciated. But that's after I had been in the store for over 15 minutes. They just have no customer service. My sunglasses alone cost more than all of them in there together. Wow. So they need to get off the trend because everybody with real money does not dress trendy. I was just visiting Atlanta and I happened to see this store. Jackson M. Get out of here, Jackson. Most expensive sunglasses in history. He's walking around with, I guess that stone from the Titanic is on his glasses. Those are the lenses, I guess.
How about his spelling?
I know. He can afford these expensive-ass glasses, but he can't spell no one.
And how about my girl and I? Me and my girl?
I'm telling you, he was so rich, he didn't have to go to school. He just, like, you know, just bought his diploma. Flight Club, Broadway, New York. All right. Oh, I very politely asked an employee for a shoe size, and he loudly roared to me, "Put the shoes back!" You know what, my fat friend? If you don't know what polite is, I could teach you for free. Just let me stand up and get out of your mother's bed. Waiting us.
That's kind of messed up. You hold up a shoe. Hey, you got this. Put that shit down.
No, put it down. Like, whoa, man. Okay. I was going to buy it, but not since you screamed at
me. They got all their shoes triple wrapped in there. All
right. Yeah,
so it's a lot of negative reviews, too. A lot of.
Put that shit down. Yeah.
All right, so the trophy room, this one, I'm telling you, I have to say this one last because this one is like a block long. The trophy room, Disney Springs, Orlando, Florida.
Dang.
Yeah, I know. Normally, I would probably give this location 5 stars. The new go-to spot for any sneakerhead for the most exclusive Jordans and merchandise. Also known as merch.
Merch.
For Skip. Skip goes hard. Kanye. Skip goes hard.
Can't get everybody calling themselves merch. Go ahead.
Skip
merch.
Goes hard. Merch.
Remind me to never say merch.
Oh, he hates that word. Skip, you and Skip, like, they hate the word merch. Wow. So not for not on anytime I even, I'm telling you right now. So, Gsnks, you got any merch?
No, I don't. You got any merch? Know. Just for the record, Skip went off through a text message.
Oh, I know. He left this block long
for saying merch.
Almost as long as this.
Mm. For saying merch.
For saying merch. So for now on, like, every episode, any chance I get, I'm going to say the word merch.
Man.
Anyway.
And I don't even remember saying it.
You must have said it because it set him off.
Saying it.
He said his fist was getting clenched. Like as he was watching a video.
I don't remember saying it.
All right. This only gets 2 stars because of how horrible the customer's, the release day procedure was. They gave out 1,200 wristbands and only had 2 registers open. I was in the 700 range and the store owner promised there would still be good retros for the public to buy. That was a lie! There was only one sort of good thing to buy. The rest was what every sneakerhead has already. Made the public wait and stand outside in the blistering hot sun for hours. I personally waited for over 12 hours. When I got inside, I couldn't get my box signed because the owner was tired. Jerk. The public who would be devoted to the store weren't tired either. Standing outside in the hot sun. There were still people behind me waiting when I got in. They should have had at least 10 registers open for the customers to accelerate the checkout process. 10 registers. Very sloppy.
Myers ain't even got 10 registers.
Right. Once inside, the staff was rude. Security tried to rush me out because I was looking at the store. Sorry! I was only trying to shop and spend my hard-earned money with you! The shop is beautiful inside, though. He went from angry to like all of a sudden just pleasantly.
But that shit was cold.
Right, it was docile. He went from angry to docile in like 2 sentences. I'm sure after the grand opening, they will fix some of the problems. But as a loyal customer to Jordan Brand for 20 years, I felt that I was abused and lied to. Get over yourself. I never had a worse sneaker release procedure. Orlando sneakerheads know how the entire Galaxy phone posit fiasco happened at the Florida malls. I will come back to try to get exclusives. But for regular stuff, it's better to go to your local mall. Marcus, I hope you read this. You misled the Orlando people with your promises. Your staff was rude to customers. Your release procedure is the worst of any store. I hope to come back when you're not tired of making millions of dollars chilling in the AC. Too busy to sign a box for the people who supported you and beloved you.
I think it was his beloved father,
like,
not him.
Jesus. Like, I mean, did he run for office? I hope this changes, because if not, I won't be coming back.
You just said you was coming.
I know. Like he. I'd rather pay resale than do what I did today. Not to mention, the wristband procedure was totally misleading, as they ended up doing it 3 hours before what was stated on their website. The staff took care of out-of-towners as the Orlando people suffered in the sun.
How you suffering?
I know, like, you would think it would be Houston. Couldn't have had a worse experience. 2 stars due to the exclusives in the beautiful store.
He liked that store.
I'm telling you, the aesthetics alone was enough to bring him back. Bad because of the way they treated the people, misled the people, the room staff, and the lies they told the people online. Giving them false hope of getting something exclusive. Damn. This is my first review I ever wrote on Yelp. Is he Tupac now? This is the realest shit I ever wrote now? hopefully it's my last. but the people need to know the truth. The trophy room's grand opening was a joke in every way. David T. David T., I'm telling you, you need to go see a therapist like right now. First of all, not only did you like transition from Malcolm X to Tupac, so you might have some type of bipolar issues or schizophrenia, but you seem to be really affected by this release. Like, he made it sound like he was a politician that lied to the people. He was abused. He said he was abused and lied to, and that the people were misled and mistreated. And I don't know. Listening to him talk, you would think that like the staff just went out there and just started like just beating the shit out of the people in line, and then went back in the store and sold them some shoes. Here's the thing about the trophy room. That was the only negative review, but it was so funny I felt like I had to read it because he was just like pissed. And Wish too. Wish also had a lot of positive reviews too. So I don't want anybody thinking, okay, like these stores are just. I mean, literally, if I can only read one negative review, that you know, that says a lot about that store. Speaking of which, I wish we had stopped by there when we was in Atlanta. I mean, I'm telling you, when we go back to Atlanta, I got so many spots to go to. I wanted to do, dang, I don't even have time to do it now. I'm gonna scratch it. Release dates. I just want to put this out there. I wanted to kind of make fun of MSU since they lost. They lost to Wisconsin, right? And I guess, you know, since they were a top 10 team, I guess you can make the excuse, okay, it can happen on any given Saturday. But then y'all followed it up with an L to Indiana, so I wasn't kind of tease y'all, but I'm going to let y'all slide. Only because we're running out of time, so y'all got lucky. Release dates, brought to you by SneakerBartyTrade.com, the number one source of sneaker news and release dates. You want to do this, girl?
Yeah, I can do it. Thursday, October 6th, the Nike SB Dunk Low Shoebox, orange and white. Those are pretty dope. Adidas Special Fall Winter 2016 Collection. Nike Women's Beautiful Powerful Collection. Friday, October 7th, Tiana Taylor Reebok Question Red October or Fire and Ice. Adidas Original Gazelle GTX City Pack. Saturday, October 8th, Air Jordan Retro 12 GS Dark Purple Dust. Air Jordan Retro 1 High OG Reverse Shatterback Board. Air Jordan 31 Shatterback Board. The Meta Sneakers Adidas Custodiums. What's that? See you later.
See you later, yeah.
Naked Van Sky High Collaboration Pastel Pack.
And I will be seeing them later because I won't ever buy them.
So is this the Jordan Westbrook 0.2 or the 2.0?
It says 0.2.
0.2 camo, European release only.
Thank God.
The Eddie Hung Adidas Originals Collection. Tamos Puma Displays Night Jungle. Undefeated Adidas EQT Supportive ADV. Lenin Way of Way White Vault.
Are those the ones you were talking about?
Yeah. Monday, October 10th, you got Adidas Crazy Explosive Triple Black. I've read and watched numerous reviews on those. Probably one of the best basketball shoes out right now.
The Crazy Explosive?
Yeah, I'm going to get them and try them out. Tuesday, October 11th, the Nike LeBron 14 Red, Yellow, White. Nike LeBron 14 White, Silver, and Orange.
Has anybody seen pictures of those yet?
No, Nike kept that. That's the first time I ain't ever seen a shoe leak this long.
Jeez.
Yeah. Friday, October 14th, Flyknit Racer Pure Platinum. Saturday, October 15th, we got the Adidas D-Row 7 White, Black, and Red. I heard that's a really good shoe to hoop in as well.
Mm-hmm.
Air Jordan Retro 3 Cyber Monday. I think I'm leaning towards getting that. The Rihanna and Puma boot. I've seen several of her shoes. They were ranging from like $375 to $600.
Yeah, here's a good one.
Nike Kobe 11 EM, which is means engineered mesh, Barcelona.
I was wondering what
That's what that means. Nike LeBron Soldier 10 Christ the King, which is one of the high schools he sponsors. Adidas Yeezy 750 Boost Light Browns.
Yeah, they retro on this. Is that a retro or is that a different colorway?
Different colorway.
Okay.
You got me jumping on that?
What's that? So,
the 750 Boost, man.
Yeah, I got you on that. I got the lighter fluid in the match.
There you go.
My dog.
Right in front of
my dog.
We'll see.
And see if you can put that fire.
Yeah, Sunday. I need to shoot, man. Mm. Sunday, October 16th, the White Mountaineering Special Edition Adidas NMD City Sock Collection. Thursday, October 20th, Nike Air Force Composite 1 Maroon is actually called the Candy Apple.
That's what they call it.
And it will be available in all sizes.
How do y'all feel about that? I'm not really feeling that.
I like
them. I don't know.
Friday, October 21st, Adidas See You Later OG. Saturday, October 22nd, you got the Air Jordan Retro 6 Pinnacle Metallic Gold.
I'm passing.
The Trophy Room and Air Jordan collab. You seen the shoes from that?
No, I haven't seen those.
Okay, I didn't see any shoes from that either. The Soulfly and the Air Jordan 23 Marlins. In I like store those. Only. Those are dope. They don't look like the Marlins, though. That shit has some black on there. Online release scheduled for Monday, October 24th. Air Jordan Retro 1 Low OG Pinnacle Metallic Silver. Tuesday, October 25th, Adidas NMD XR1 Camo Pack. Then we got Friday, October 28th, Nike Air Footscape Women's Cheka SC Dark Gray Vachetta Tan, Obsidian Black Wolf Gray, and the Court Purple Black are the Nike Air Footscape Motions, which I think is probably more of a men's. And then Saturday, October 29th, we got the Air Jordan Retro 4 Premium Ginger, which I like a whole lot. And then the Nike LeBron Soldier 10 SFG Camo. And we got the Air Jordan Retro 3 GS Blue Cap. And then Sunday, October 30th, Adidas Climber Cool 1 Precious Metal Pack.
I was going to start butchering the threes like they did the ones for a long time. Like, I don't know. Like, first of all, I thought they said they was going to put the threes in the vault. I guess they only meant for like 6 months. but that Blue Cap, is, I don't know. And then there's another one. That's another colorway that, I don't know, doesn't look that good on the three. But we'll see as they come out. Still no official release dates for the Toy Story Vans collection. The Puma Ignite Evo Knit 2017 releases. I actually like that, Puma Ignite. The Weeknd, and he has a collab with Puma that's coming out early next year. You got the Adidas Ultra Boost ATR Mid Street, the Adidas Futurecraft MFG, the Yeezy Season 4 Boots, or the Book of Eli's. The Adidas Yeezy 350 Boost V2, Turtle Dove, and Oxford Tan, and Black and Gold. The Nike Air Force One Low, Kuji, the Nike Air Presto Greedy, the Nike Women's Air Max Thea Mid, the Nike Roshi 2 Flyknit 365. You got the Nike Air Max Zero Mint Green, the Nike Hyperdunk Flyknit 2016 colorways, the Nike Air Max 90 Amber Glow, the Nike Air Python Premium Red Snakeskin. This is dope. I can't wait to see when these come out. The Nike Special Forces Air Force One. Y'all seen those? Mm-mm. Real futuristic, funky looking boots. They made for the military, though, allegedly.
They trying to military ball on somebody.
Man, yeah, they. you got the Nike Air Unlimited Retro, those David Robinson joints. You also have the Nike Kobe 11 Elite 4KB Day of the Dead. Those actually look real dope, too. That may be the second pair of Kobe 11s that I like. The Nike Air Foamposite 1 Royal. Coming out next year.
January.
The upcoming Jordan CP3 10 colorways. Nobody's looking for those. The Air Jordan 11 Golf Shoe. The Air Jordan Retro 1 High Deep Royal. The Air Jordan Retro 1 High Premium GS Night Maroon. Those look beautiful. As well as the 11s. And the Air Jordan Retro 12 3 Unreflective. Real quick. Those wool 11s look like shit.
They're not wool. That looks suede.
I don't know. They calling it wool. They call it what you want to. Just call it not bought.
Like, you like shoes, them?
The 11s? Yeah.
You like those suede, wool 11s?
Maybe. Oh, you ain't going to ask me, huh?
Really?
You already know, right?
All suede 11s, y'all don't like that?
You already know, right?
They don't like it?
I don't know. Like, I mean,
are they serious?
Yeah.
All suede 11? Yeah. All suede 11, you don't like it?
Yeah.
Dude, we're gonna have to have
this, I think it's like taking the elephant print off a three and saying, do you like it?
When
you do that with the, I just,
wool ain't meant to go on everything. I'm telling you, first of all,
12s was, because you still had suede, some leather with the rubber with it, but you just took away the whole.
We know what shoe we're talking about.
I'm not, the quality is probably there. Trash. The quality is there, but I don't care for
Garbo.
That's why there's so many different shoes out there for people to choose.
Jumpman being the voice of reason. Like, that's, man,
it's,
I'm saying,
awesome. You don't like these either, right?
I like those.
Okay, but you really can't.
I don't hate those.
Tell the print because it's black. Yeah. So
is the print of it on
you just
there?
Mentioned?
But I'm
taking
is,
it all.
The print isn't on there. Is it?
No, it's tumbled leather.
Yeah, right.
The leather and the elephant print made the Retro 3.
Okay, that's, but it's not on this. So, but you're saying that you don't like this, or but you're saying you do like
but
it. Which
just
one
the
is
fact,
it?
Just the fact that they took it off. It's not like they permanently taken off. Just the fact that they took it off one shoe. That Cyber Monday 3 is
hell. The wool. Prime example. The wool 3s is terrible. I don't care for the wool 3s.
I don't either.
So it's not
either. You like these.
Yes, I like those.
But okay, but you're saying that it's it's not the same model without the elephant print.
When you do whole, if you took the patent leather off and put regular leather, I could have tolerated it. But when you do that whole wheel, like, and it looks, it don't even look sturdy.
It looks cheap. Honestly, it don't look like $400 to me.
First
I'm
of
sorry.
All, that's, we only seen one picture.
Yeah, and I'm basing right. my, right, and I'm basing it on that one picture.
One picture.
Now, if okay. they come up with better pictures, then one I would picture. Change my decision. But one as picture. Of now.
It's garbage as of now.
As of now, it's garbage. That's what I'm, it's well, not worth $400.
Well, since we bashing stuff right now, can somebody, who knows where the University of Michigan Air Jordan display is being
it's in
displayed.
The Chrysler Arena inside yeah. where the basketball player
okay play. Can you please call somebody and tell them to take the 2010s out the 2009 box and put them in the right box? They got the 2009s and 2010s switched, so they got the 2000
who did that?
I don't know. They got the 2010s in the 2009 box and they got the 2009s and 2010s.
Let me guess,
box.
The person putting the box together was wearing some Yeezys.
Had to had
that was
to.
Ugly
they killing no, like us those. Right now
I, said I show them
somebody yeah. need to get fired for that
terrible.
Which I, said should, I said they should have more black in them.
Terrible.
The 23.
I ain't mad at those.
I think they should have more black in them.
I agree. They should
like
have more black
too. In them. I like those.
I like those.
I like them.
I like those. That's a good colorway on that, especially with that clear part on that shoe. Is like the 23s?
Yeah, yeah, I like.
Yeah, we talking about the, what's that, Soulfly Jordan
yeah.
23
yeah, Marlins.
But don't, I mean, look, don't wool joints, right, man, look, it ain't no saving those, man. Especially, and they got that stamp on the heel. Hey, look, man, look, dude, don't look like some yeah. basic ass.
That like, confuses a lot of people.
I don't even know what store would carry those, Ross.
Carry what? I'm sorry.
I agree.
Throwing the 11 still. Because they got that stamp on the heel, too. That's like ridiculous.
Man, I don't think that's a stamp. I think that was a watermark for the
that's
picture.
That's a stamp. Look at the picture.
Yeah, I just stamp, looked at
bro.
It.
That's a stamp.
That's a stamp. They're in Boston.
Yeah, that
stamp.
Thing is in Boston. And that ain't no watermark.
Oh, them bitches code. It's like, I knew y'all was going to say
that. Oh, man. I'm about to go to a coma. I'm about to go to a self-induced coma.
I knew y'all was gonna say
until
that.
Next Monday.
Disagreeing on certain shoes makes it fun, bro.
Yeah, it does.
It does. It makes it
I'm
fun.
I had so much hope because I don't know who I don't know who.
Whatever
did.
Shoe we all agree on, we should just wear that shoe.
We should.
Oh, that's Steph Cody.
Somebody, because when they first mentioned the Wolves, somebody had made up a picture, and the picture looked up. I was like, man, these might turn out nice. And then I saw the real thing, and I'm like, man
these boys gonna be cold, boy.
Man, I'm fighting somebody.
That suede look crazy.
I'm going on a one-man rampage.
If you had the leather upper with the wool wrapped
why
around
does it
yes,
have
to, thank you.
That why like, does it have to be what you want?
I'm saying.
Because I'm going to be the person
you ain't got
it.
The answer, Sway. You ain't got the answer.
You want me to spend $400?
You ain't got the answer, Sway.
I would like the thing, if you're going to spend $400, you like the shoe.
Man, this shoe probably going to be amazing when you see it. This is one picture, a sample picture at that.
Okay. Ain't that the point of talking about it?
I guess so. Maybe you do got the answers right now, Sway.
Right now, I'm basing it on that. Like, if something comes out.
They should just throw that clear soul on
me. Can you help me get that wool 11?
No. Trust me.
Y'all gonna have no Sway wool 11.
Only thing I'm gonna need as far as 11s is those.
Can I at least get a look at the picture?
Space Jam. I'm letting y'all know now. They bought a lot. It's gonna be way more than
yeah,
the
it is. It's probably gonna be the biggest release.
Everybody gonna be the station.
You know, have you been checking out YouTube how many different.
Version.
Videos yeah. people have been putting out. It's supposed to be tissue at the front of the box and the back of the box, and it's supposed to be tissue over the
listen.
Plastic.
Yeah,
heel,
the shoe tree is supposed to have two.
Play it safe and go to the store.
Wait till the damn.
Do
shoe
not
come
buy
out.
Them online. What, go, unless it's from the sneakers app or whatever. Just be
don't
safe.
Panic, y'all. Just don't panic. Don't
I
panic.
I wish though, if I had only one gripe about the Space Jams, is I wish it had. You know, the originals I had said Jumpman Jam.
Yeah,
I wish it said that. That's okay. The only thing. That's the only thing I wish. It said,
instead of Jumpman Jordan.
Yeah, because that I mean, that's what made it special to me when it first came out. I was like, oh, it said Jumpman Jam. I like the cut of the patent leather. It's like a little bit thicker.
That's how it was supposed to be. Like all the old.
Yeah, all the old.
People don't
like
realize
that.
You was getting gypped for those patent leather all these years.
Yeah,
yeah. The originals had that. Dang, the whole toe box area was patent leather.
Yeah, man, they ain't giving you this interesting
leather. Can't wait
leather.
To do that review. Of
and it's real patent leather, too, because it got that white trim.
And that widow's peak, as they call it, on three different sides of the patent leather.
Yeah. I don't like
now, are they coming out with the Space Jam
like
jersey?
Line. I don't like the white line.
Because I know they're coming out with, like, clothes or, like, a collection
of
clothes.
Yeah, I heard they got the rights with Warner Brothers, so they're going to be making a lot of clothes with the Bugs Bunny and all.
Boy, they come with the jersey or no?
I never know. Okay. I probably more likely they will.
All right, well, looking forward to that.
I want to get the warm up jacket though.
Oh yeah, the whole they should bring the whole jogging suit. That'd be dope.
They probably will. You see somebody playing basketball in this
space. Man, that dude gonna have a whole jogging suit on.
He probably already got
on the court
it.
Again.
He probably do. Man. He probably stunting right now on somebody.
He'll be on the court again with it. They gonna get him a whole. They,
they,
him a,
they do a green screen and he'll get some monsters.
All them people that reposted that laughing at him should laugh at themselves because all they do is get him noticed.
Dog. You know? They gonna have him in the new movie. He gonna be on the Toon Squad.
Oh, man. Well, it's a LeBron movie, so I don't know if it's gonna.
They shouldn't have never done that.
How?
I thank you.
The whole damn
Everything don't need a sequel. They doing
that
a Jumanji sequel.
That
they doing
alone.
This.
The whole damn. What the hell is LeBron going to do in there? Like,
I don't know.
Try to just make him look.
My
like,
thing is, I agree.
Better than Mike.
I think.
Hopefully they don't have the 2011 Dallas Mavericks team. Hopefully they don't steal their powers.
Just like they wanted him to be the first player to come back from a 3-1 deficit to win the NBA.
Oh, he about to start.
Man, that's what's so rigged, man.
Here we go.
It was rigged, bruh.
They was tired of you losing to the Pistons, so they took away hand checking.
Let me tell you something. We was tired of Mike wasn't tired of losing to the Pistons. And it was Scotty
LeBron
and the migraines.
LeBron
Horace Grant scared to rebound.
Yeah. LeBron never and LeBron man, never look, kept nobody off the USA
you know,
basketball
the,
team either.
The thing
that's
is,
right.
This is
gonna
Isaiah be interesting.
Was a hater.
No,
Isaiah everybody hated Isaiah hater. At that time, though.
Isaiah was a hater, and you know it.
This Barkley was a hater.
This
is
gonna be interesting because the Mon Stars, you know, they known to play rough and foul and all that. So what are they gonna do?
My thing is, I agree. They probably should have gave him a different movie not to go back after that because everybody was fell in love. And then you waited so long to do something. So my thing is, I don't.
Now
think
here come the Michael Jordan comparisons. That's my thing.
I think
there they come.
I don't think they should.
Who else could you compare?
No, I agree. It's like, why are you, dude? Like LeBron, be LeBron. Like these constant comparisons to Michael Jordan only hurt you. They do not help you.
My thing is, one media did it. So.
But he had to, I mean, he signed the contract to do the movie.
Oh, yeah.
He could have said, no, I'm not going to mess with that. Let's
do something
else.
Space Jam
2.
Like, he could have did a Disney.
Ryan, go talk to him.
He could have did a Space Jam with Disney characters.
Talk to your boy.
Like, you know, like,
he could have did a LeBron Jam.
Yeah,
not even worse.
That'd be
even worse. Now you sound like Shaq. Now you sound like Shaq.
That'd be straight to DVD right there.
The flop.
The flop. There we go. He gonna be. They gonna be in there. He
you know
me.
That man.
He fouled me.
Superstar car.
And it's gonna be Airbus 7.
Superstar.
LeBron and his dog.
LeBron Bud 7.
Running amok in the NBA.
King flop.
Here
we go.
Here we go.
Here
a
we
perfect
go.
Movie.
No, you know what would have been a good movie if they would have did the sequel to Celtic Pride.
Well, LeBron.
Yeah, they kidnapped
LeBron James and Damon Wayans.
Yeah, they
kidnapped LeBron.
That would have been dope, though.
Oh,
that would have been dope. Cavalier Pride, Cav Pride.
Since we're doing, I mean, sure.
That would have been dope.
Oh my God,
Cav Pride or Eddie Folk. Or 83. Which number?
Whoopi Goldberg.
Yep. Whoopi Goldberg.
Oh, man. God. Okay. I
don't want y'all to think I dislike LeBron. LeBron is
a
great player.
I take it for you.
He's a great player, and I have respect for him.
I take it.
But he is not Mike.
No.
Period. He ain't my thing is.
Kobe.
My thing is, I'm trying to tell you, neither one of those players are each other. Because Kobe was better.
Dave was
trying
to wrap it up.
Jordan and Brian. LeBron's a better passer and rebounder than both of them. Jordan was more consistent scorer than both
He's a better passer than who?
Hey, cut this guy mic off.
Who, LeBron? You talking about LeBron?
He ain't AI either.
Who? Stop, LeBron, man. LeBron was a better passer
I'll tell you, Michael Jordan assist skills.
You
is
said
the
he was better
underrated.
Passer than Mike.
LeBron not a better passer than Michael Jordan?
No.
Oh, my God.
No.
Man, no, we don't need y'all. Hey.
No.
Don't hit him.
Yeah.
Chill.
No.
Watch out.
Are you serious?
I'm telling you, that might be the most underrated
man,
skill
can we
Michael
ban
Jordan.
Him from 99?
So
he just come back for 100.
Are you serious?
He need to take a show off.
Are you serious
off,
to say that Michael Jordan was a better passer?
Guru just got it.
Better
passer.
We got assists and video for
Guru
you.
Guru just got
better.
Suspended come from on, episode 99.
If we had time, I swear to God, we'll just pull up the stats. Even the stats don't tell
they in here story. Fighting. We just got a technical foul.
Don't listen to you. You're going to get yours.
Public
enemy.
Fighting right now, and I'm about to comment.
That's where his 98 Oldsmobile
is
in there.
They
fight.
I can't believe this guy
technical
says.
Foul. Guru just got suspended for episode 99.
Wow.
It's going down right now.
Man, they said you.
I'm going to send you some videos of Mike's.
He had a flagrant.
I'm
flagrant.
I'm going to send you some.
Flagrant.
Guru just got flagged for a flagrant.
Flagrant and a technical foul. He suspended one game.
LeBron had a flagrant foul.
LeBron passed the ball when he should shoot the ball because he's scared. Because he's scared.
Guru got caught deflating some football, so he's going to be suspended for a couple games.
How do you feel about this right now,
Sam? I'm going to jump in.
How many times has LeBron disappeared in the game? How many times has Mike disappeared?
Come on, man. Who got
Don't start stuttering.
Come on, man.
But how long did it take LeBron to get to the playoffs? Like, come on, man.
His second year. Jordan got bounced the first round.
JumpmanBostic just took off his belt.
Who's on his top? I know. Yeah, he took off his belt.
Man, look. LeBron always had a surrounding cast.
No, he did not. 2000 and what?
Until he went to Miami, right?
So he played 8 years to Miami, right? He played 8 years of scrub.
Hold on, time out, dog. Here we go. Wait, time out.
Time out. 8, 9.
This dude, his team had the best record in the NBA 2 years before he went to Miami. The last 2 years. Oh, dang. Dave out there. Okay, Dave's trying to make a point.
You know, we're going to pick this up.
We're going to pick this up this week. Dave was like, look, y'all ain't got to go home.
I'm bringing the action.
But y'all
got to
get the hell out of here.
We picking this up.
Sneaker Podcast and bring you the action of live feed right now. We got an in-game battle going on right now.
Yeah.
They fighting. They got their shirts off. They scrapping.
Hey, real quick, shout outs to my man, Skip
Somebody
Goes Hard.
Might believe that.
And also, remember to use Creptech, the official partners of the Sneaker Boss Podcast, to clean and protect your shoes from anything life or nature throws at it. Get the most out of your sneakers, practice safe stunting, and go to creptech.com to get your shoes some protection.
Shaking his head.
I know, yeah, he is pissed. I can see the steam coming off his forehead.
He's like, he get his notes for next week already.
Jumpman, what's your word, dog?
He calling his lawyer to appeal the decision.
His morning word going to be Jordan is a better.
Cleveland, they won 20 games. When Jordan retired, they still won 54 games.
Man, he's so discombobulated, he's stuttering.
Hey, oh. Time out, though. But they did lose some players, and they lost their coach. So it's not a fair comparison because the variables did change.
Only one person. When Barnes left, he was the only person that left when he went to Miami.
There were some other players that left.
Team up with two other superstars chasing a championship. Did Mike leave his team? Did Magic? Did Larry?
Because free agency wasn't back then. You drafted well.
They wouldn't have done it if it was.
No. How? How can you say that, bro?
Because they want to beat the best players on the team. They don't want to team up with them. You know that, man.
Oh, Jumpman.
Man, I can't wait till 99, wow, man. Guru, come with it, man.
Jumpman is like, I call Guru.
And don't wear no Jordans in here, neither.
You better
wear some LeBron. Wear some LeBron.
I'm proud doing that.
Wear some LeBrons up in here.
We ain't had to change the rules to get the
And put on the 23 jersey.
We got Mayweather versus Pacquiao.
It's like Jumpman called him to play football. He was like, you are
suspended. And I need another can, man. I didn't bring enough.
Hey, Guru, in the show a piece, buy him some Mountain Dew.
I'm gonna have to stop at the store on the way home. He done got me refired up.
Got you fired up, Jumpman.
I'm going right here to the gas station. Get me a
Jumpman is fired up right now, baby.
He said he getting a Tully.
Man, he's still talking about he a better pass. The morning word. You never know how strong you are until being strong is the only choice you have. I understand you being strong right now. That's the only choice you have.
Okay. We're out of here.
You ain't
man.
Never heard the morning word get intertwined with a battle like this.
No. Oh, man. Okay.
We got to sign out on that one, Caesar.
Oh, yeah. On that note, man, I am the African Caesar.
JumpmanBostic.
And Gsnks 89
coming. Tune in for 99.
No, he is pissed.
Because Guru is suspended for 99. Yeah. He would not be there.
99 nothing. I'm being here. Yeah.
Mike on mute. He going to be here, but his mic going to be on mute.
No, I want him. He reinstated.
Oh, man. Oh, you want
it's not
here.
Dez Bryant.
Okay.
They tried to do me like that did Isaiah. Yeah. They tried to do me like that did Isaiah. You see
okay.
that?
The decision has been appealed. He's won his appeal. And he will be here.
If I was Mike, I'd have let you participate in the Olympics because you needed that gold medal for your legacy. Isaiah.
You got Gsnks 89 about to bring you all the live feed from the battle. They ain't fighting, going crazy, flipping tables. I'm going to bring it all to you. All
right, man. All right, we'll see you guys next week.
Guru.
Episode 99.
Bring your LeBrons, bruh.
Hey.
Like straight LeBron. To the flop
like
feet.
LeBron. I don't got prime passing up on mics.
Bring them floppy. Bring them floppy LeBron.